Also, here in daytime, it looks like things are pretty normal. The sky is looking very normal and blue and not full of galaxy shenanigans. I'm guessing these are player characters. Yep, these are player characters. I was like, some people are standing out slightly. What's up, Zing? Yeah, exactly, man. This is a game that came out, we're talking about Fear. The game that came out like the mid-2000s, I think, was a significant game in the sense that it had like all this cool physics stuff you could do. This was back when like ragdoll physics were like a new exciting thing. It had some really cool psychological thriller aspects to it and some cool weapons. There were a lot of things that were attractive about this game, but yeah, back in the day, there's no way I could run it just because the family computer I had could not hold up to scrutiny. But now, since the game is, it's like 15, 16 years old, Zing's probably right. I mean, looking at the specs of my phone, it would probably be comparable at least. Obviously, I wouldn't want to play a first-person shooter on my phone. Which is not to say that that's like the worst thing ever. I know that there are people that have done such things. But yeah, regardless. So here we are. So actually, the night sky looks pretty normal in these parts. Up in the favored sections, we were seeing some pretty wild shit. In fact, I'm kind of curious to see if we go back to the gate. Is it possible? You were not favored? I mean, I'm pretty sure I'm... Well, I mean, they're not wrong. They're not wrong. I'm not favored. It's true, but I am like fancy enough, where I'm able to budget. Cause the camera is borked, and the rope is. Yeah, so it looks like the truck did get exploded. Can I still climb up this? I don't see the rope, unfortunately. Yeah, so the van still exploded. Oh, also I need to change my auto settings really quick. But I did not set that earlier. There we go, yeah. Yeah, I've learned over the weeks of streaming this game with my current audio setup, I've learned that if I stream this with my default audio setup, I can hear the game just fine, and it sounds just fine on your guys' end. But that there are times when certain gameplay elements don't get rendered to me, to my speakers, and specifically the cutscenes and some of the dialogue. Most of it, but some of the dialogue, as well as cutscene dialogue, does not get rendered to me or does not get propagated to my speakers, but it does go to the stream. So I have to change the default settings back to something else. Just to, instead, because the thing is that I've got like a 5.1 surround sound set up. You can see one of the speakers right here. Looking to see if that rope's going to respawn, because I want to go back up that way if possible, but it's possible that we might not be able to return anytime soon. Yeah, that's kind of unfortunate. Yeah, okay, so that's a little bit unfortunate. We can't go back to, like, see the night sky with how it looked previously, but this is still pretty cool. What I will instead do, though, is scoot my little booty back this way. Actually, what's this guy doing out? Because it's nighttime. Shouldn't the Anointed not be out at nighttime? This is interesting. Also, there's that guy with, like, their computers on. They're stacked with six in a single room, by the way. So I guess maybe the Anointed are allowed at night. I know that the Foundlings are not allowed at nighttime. They have to observe a very strict curfew, but maybe not so much here. Every time I see this, like, red kind of clay dirt, I always think it's blood on the ground, and I'm always like, oh, what's going on here? So we did take on an additional side quest. There's more side quests to be done at nighttime specifically, which I was not aware of. I didn't know that there were more side quests at night. Let's find a way to sabotage a truck. Yes, we gotta see if we can, like, I don't know, cut some brake lines or shit like that. Oh, tell me I'm gonna stick some corn in the tailpipe, please. Merciful Batman, tell me I'm gonna shove, yes, the corn in the tailpipe, the oldest trick in the book. That way I'm disrupting their supply lines and fucking shit up. Sabotage the second truck. Can I just, like, take a dump in the fucking oil tank or something? Or remove the battery and like, eat it or something? Or switch it out with, here we go, yeah, what's this guy? Switch out the battery for, I don't know. One of the decapitated heads of the monsters that's over here. Take out the spark plug. Find something to destroy it with, okay. So something nearby, there is! Ooh, a crowbar! Oh, we're gonna Gordon Freeman this shit, hell yeah. Destroy it. Smack. Yeah, there we go. That's satisfying. were sabotaging shit from the inside. You'd love to see it. Inventory is full. Shocking, absolutely nobody. Inventory is full, and of course my stuff here is filling out quite quickly, quite rapidly even. So let's do this. Get that one. Bloop. Leveled up to 13 on that one, and I think that's it for now. Now I can collect them, and I shall. I will, and I shall. Priority always, good to see you, my friend. Yeller to you as well, my friend. Like a lot of us had that one, either it was there, it was our dad, or it was that, it was like we had a friend who had a dad that did this, where when they picked up the phone, it wasn't hello, it was yellow. Always. Always and forever. It's good to see the priority always. Hope you're doing well, my friend. Doing some more Noita, that's correct, yeah. No, I was talking about this a little bit earlier. I've kind of got like a game plan as far as like the next major things I'm going to be streaming. And yes, absolutely, Noita is 100% on the list as well. So what I'm thinking I'll probably do is something similar to what I was doing previously, where I would play Hyrule Warriors and then switch off with Noita from time to time as a way to balance it out. Because Hyrule Warriors is great, but it's sometimes a little bit samey. Noita also can get a little bit samey, like, so I don't know if I'd be able to stream either one for, you know, 4, 5, 6 hours completely uninterrupted. But doing 2 or 3 hours of each sounds much nicer, so I think that's something that I'll be able to do, pretty soon, actually, because like I said, we're gonna be wrapping up this game, most likely at least, within, there's a chance we could wrap it up tonight, probably within either tonight or Thursday, because Thursday will be the next planned or scheduled stream that I have, as well as bonus streams over the weekend, probably. So, I mean, I guess at the very latest, it'll be this weekend, but maybe today, probably Thursday, when I'll be wrapping up this game, and once it's done, it opens up the floodgates as far as all the stuff I want to play. I've mentioned that I want to start by doing something really quick, just because this game has been very long. And it's been good, but it's been a very long project, so I like the idea of doing some shorter stuff. So we'll start off by doing a playthrough of Hotline Miami, which is a game I've played before. So second or maybe third playthrough. And I like it a lot, but it's a pretty short game. So we'll do that one before getting into like Hyrule Warriors and Noita. There's a lot that I want to do, so I've got like this unending list of shit to stream and things I want to do and YouTube videos I want to make. So it's like, man, I'm keeping myself very busy. Also, Beer Addict and Jay, good to see you, friend. A piece of content that I... what is the Seek and Preserve scenario, Jay? I'm interested. There are winged horrors, by the way. That's gotta get its attention. Can I jump on this car and smack it or something? Can't do that. Find something to get the bad guy's attention, that red lad. Let's join up with our friend Jay. Yeah, the Seek and Preserve scenario. Yeah, I don't think I've seen that one, and I'm very curious. Streets of Rogue, I have. Yeah, I've seen the game. I think I've watched a little bit of it streamed, but I haven't watched much of it. Ooh, it's a duo elite. Yeah, yes, I am down. So I'm guessing this will switch me over. Yeah, we can do that real quick. Oh, it's like, yeah, it's one of like the defense scenario things. Yeah, that makes sense. Or simulation, rather. It's really good. Hell yeah, dude. Yeah, I do enjoy a lot of roguelikes. I do enjoy a lot of them. I don't enjoy every single one. Like, I find that I'm sometimes a little bit picky. But yeah, Streets of Rogue has been recommended. And it's been recommended to me. And I've seen little bits about it, so I'm curious. Also, Puzzwell, absolutely. Good to see you, friend. And yes, absolutely. Yeah, like I said, that'll be a nice and... I mean, it's not an easy game, but I think it'll be a nice and fairly doable... like quick game. I mean, it's not an easy game, but it's fairly quick and it's a fun one to play. And also, I need to get around to playing 2 eventually, just because that game is also on my list. Also, there's Jay and with an outfit that once again is always on point. She's blending in very well with the cool blue light for the little start icon that she's on right now. So once I know she's loaded in, we'll go ahead and hop in and get this thing started. I'm glad you're here, Puzzle. I'm glad everyone is here. Thank you all for being here, friends. I've been live for about 20 minutes or so, and we already have a bunch of very nice people that are chilling with us today, and I'm very grateful for all of you sharing part of your evening with me.
Welcome to this virtual training
Cataclysm,
scenario.
Dark Days.
The Council
I haven't heard of that
would
one.
Like to remind you that it
is
takes
it on Steam,
no
Jay?
Responsibility for accidental death, maiming, or insanity during the course of this exercise. This simulation is designed to prepare you for the pressures of a
field
career.
Oh, this one where you, yeah, you rescue survivors. I did this in the old version of the game.
Your actions,
but I haven't seen this one. I haven't seen
weighed,
this version of it.
And your success will be based on your ability to remain on mission throughout. As the scenario progresses,
free to download. Excellent. Cool. Thank you, Jay. Thank you for the recommendation. I shall absolutely look that up.
Spectral disturbance.
I'm always down for recommendations. Puzzlewell's got a couple recommendations too. Yeah, I like. I'm always down for recommendations. I can't make any guarantees, obviously, just because, like I said, I've got a long list of games to play, and it's not always a good fit for streaming necessarily. But yeah, I'm always down for ideas and suggestions. Got to find ourselves some survivors, and here we go. We found some. So we got to defend these fellas and Cinderellas, and then escort them out. Also, I need to get into the. Actually, no, I'm already in the group.
New waves of hostiles have arrived. Protect the survivors.
Loud! Wow! Loud audio! Holy fuck! That guy was like, yo, we gotta protect some dudes. Holy fuck. Yeah, more effigies of things. We've seen this before. More like effigies. Now, I thought I saw something over this way. Something spooky this way comes. Oh, it's just the little, right, just the little skull things. Little floating skull friends. Grab that. Of course, we got like a healing dilly bopper over there, which is nifty. Interesting that this is a duo mission or duo simulation or scenario. That's the word I'm looking for. And that it's like limited to just two people, which is interesting. Oh, this way. Here it is. I was like, wait, what am I doing? Yeah, and of course, we got the survivors that will help. They're not defenseless. They're here to chill with us.
Spawning enhanced hostile.
All right, that one wasn't quite as loud. That first message, he was like, whoo, max volume. Cataclysm's good? Yeah, yeah. Yeah, we got the J and the Puzzle Well recommendation. I know it's going to be some good shit. If both J and Puzzle Well recommend it, I know it's going to be good times for all. And by all, at least mean me. Definitely good times for me. Good times for Alex. Bit more of a learning curve, but it's still, yeah, really, really cool and fascinating, yeah. Oh, Katana Zero and Ruiner. Yes, I own both of those games. One of my buddies played Katana Zero when it first came out and loved it so much. He has raved about it to me. More times than I can count, honestly. Like he's really, really recommended it highly. So yeah, I have gotten a personal recommendation of that game multiple times, and I've seen it on, what was it? I think I saw it on one of the GDQs one year. I think I saw it on doing, you know, speedruns, that is, and one of the games done quick marathons, and I don't know if I've seen it, like, streamed necessarily, but I've definitely seen a bit of the game, and it looks incredible. And Ruiner looks fucking wild. That game looks fucking dope. I am absolutely interested in that game. It looks really cool. It looks really very menacing and dark and just badass. Some cool like sci-fi, cyberpunky kind of vibes. And yeah, 100% down for that one too. The dude, I'm thinking about like the dude with the main protagonist that you play as, the dude with the, like, I guess he's a robot. He's got like the robot face, like the face visor thing, and he's got like "kill you" written along the top. It's like, or along the front. It's like, oh, it's so fucking badass and menacing. I love that shit, dude. I need more of that shit in my life. Cause Katana's like, yeah, that's exactly how my friend Josh described it. He's like, yo, my love for this game borders on unhealthy. Alex, I need you to play this so I have somebody to nerd out to with this game, because holy actual shit, it's amazing. Yeah, yeah, I've heard it's so fucking good. And I was like over at his place one time and he was showing me a little bit of the game, and like, yeah, I can tell it looks dope. It looks tough, but very much worth. So sign my ass, and maybe also the rest of my body, but definitely my ass up. Sign my ass up. Yeah, see, there's also bad guys over this way. Seems like it's all coming in from this one side. And of course, unsurprisingly, Jay is holding it down like a boss. Also, I'm guessing the health thing is for us.
Large hostile specimens spawn.
We got a big
boy. Be prepared.
I'm prepared. Prepare yourselves. Ooh, Jay seems to know where it's gonna be. Oh, here's the big boy. Paging one big boy. Ooh, I couldn't stun that ability. He's making some mushrooms. Oh, and then Jay yeets him towards her. Actually, no, my understanding is that to yeet is to launch them away. Initiate to yoink is to locate pull them towards you. So she yoinked them. The old yoinkerino. Let's preserve some survivors. Hello, I'm here to preserve. I'm guessing, oh, it's the intro. All right, because now we got some breathing time, breathing space. Hello, it's okay, I'm here to save you, says the scary chipmunk mask man. Do not be afraid. I am your savior and totally not a chipmunk demon person with spiky
spawn protocols engaged. Jacket.
I promise it's nothing weird. I mean, it is weird, actually. It's very weird, but I'm the good weird. I promise. It's either me or zombies and fungus monsters, so I guess, you know, pick your poison. Pick your least scary thing. I think the survivors so far have not been damaged, or if they have, it's been very minimal. Ooh, we're fast now, hell yeah. Now I wonder if I was of a healer persuasion, if I'd be able to heal them, if I'd be able to target them and heal them. Or since they're like the main objective, if they would be resistant to healing, unfortunately. Because I know that there's a few other instances in the game where you have to, you're kind of limited. Jace, to check this shit out? Ooh, what am I checking at? Ooh, big boy. Big spooky boy. Oh, and then there's meat monk. We've seen these guys before. Meat ghost monk. Yeah, it's greatly reduced. Okay, cool. Oh, yeah, the rug. Looking at the rug. That's that. I'm guessing that's... Oh, it's look at Jay's badass outfit. That's what it is. Hell yeah. Yeah, she looks like one of the zombies from Kingsmith. The track zombie, specifically. That's incredible. I love this. That's cool that you can unlock the zombie dealios. Now, is that a limited time, like a single use kind of thing, or is that something you can just don whenever you want it? As I seem to recall in the old version of the game, there was some kind of deal where, oh god, some kind of deal where you could like temporarily wear limited time outfits like that. I can't remember the exact context. Oh, there we go. Yeah, they did get filthified a little bit. So yeah, healing is possible, but it's reduced. That's what I was thinking. Like, it's possible, but it's greatly reduced, so. The Grim... That's it! Yeah, the Grim Glamour, that's it, yeah.
Spawning enhanced hostile.
That's cool that they carried that over in this game, too. How do you get the Grim Glamours? Is that from certain events, or do you have to get those through caches and such? Just knocks their asses down. They're like, well, we're being defended from zombies, which is good. What's less good is it's a scary zombie lady, but I guess we'll deal. Now, of course, those AoEs that they're dropping are not doing us any favors. I guess that's kind of inevitable, though. And of course, this is a scenario where we're like surviving waves and trying to keep that whole thing going. So we're at wave 2 out of question mark. So it's really just go as long as we can.
Spawning enhanced hostile.
Oh, in the museum! That makes sense. That's where it belongs. In a museum. Oh, got more explodies, which means that person's gonna get bodied. Oh, maybe not. Looks like it was only targeting us, actually. Oh, there it is. Yep, yeah, they pop like filth balloons. It's fine, though. Like I said, it's inevitable, so I'm not gonna be a stickler. There's a ghosty friend that keeps exploding on us, but then it disappears whenever it explodes. Here's some ghosty friends. It's like it always disappears afterwards, so it's like we're unable to actually fight it. It might just be a every once in a while AoE thingy, as opposed to being a specific monster.
Spawning enhanced hostile.
There's a certain lord. Right, I gotcha. There's the punchy. I think that increases our damage.
Died. Adjusting score parameters.
A survivor has died. I guess they're not a survivor anymore, are they? I guess I'm gonna have a big boy at some point too.
Extremely aggressive hostile created. Brace for arrival.
I'm bracing. Oh, here, let me grab this. And I'm on my way. I'm slowly walking because I can't run. There we go. Nice job of interrupting that attack. And the troll has been dethroned or detrolled.
Seek and preserve parameters have been met. Initiating reward protocol.
Oh, it's just
reality simulation.
Two waves, there we go. Okay. Yeah, I was thinking it was gonna be a lot spicier. Cause the scenario we did with like a full group, that one was like, that just goes forever. That one at least had an end in sight, which is nice. Thank you to Jay for showing me the ropes on that one. That was a good one. I didn't realize that was in this game, because I remember it from the old version. But I didn't remember it being in this one. Can do another one? Yeah, I'm down. If there's multiple versions. Oh, there's three maps, yeah. I'm absolutely down for that, my friend. That sounds good. Grab the rest of these. Got lots of stuff to turn in. Including this guy, which is now max level. And now I need new elementalism focus. Which means I don't have anything to like spend a weapon stuff on for a while, so it's gonna be a little bit strange. Whoops. Yeah, don't do that. Put that back. Slap that in. There we go. Give that to this guy. Actually, we'll give that to this one. 16 with that. Hell yes. And that's critical rating. That goes to... Oh, not you. It goes to... Not you either. Critical rating. I think I might need to max this one out. As I think. I'm not 100% certain. Yeah, that one's just a single pip. So we'll keep that in there for now. But I'll want to replace it with this one getting maxed out. So yeah, that'll be something to work on. So put that back. Let's just get rid of a few things. Let's get rid of this guy. Get rid of this guy. Let's clear out some spaces. Hope your employees do not mind that I borrow their frequency in order to congratulate you, he says. Well, thank you. We didn't get any like additional gear, just some experience. Yeah, there's three maps, but they're random. Oh, right. Yeah, there's the AoEs, which can happen for sure. Let me go ahead and go through the exit. Loop. I'm guessing it will kick us back to Agartha. Oh, it takes me back to New Dawn. Okay, so it begins us anew. Cataclysm Dark Days Ahead. I want to Google that real quick. Because I am interested. I'm going to have it open so I can do some research after the stream ends. Cataclysm Dark Dank Days Ahead. There it is. Ooh, when you say roguelike, you mean like literally a roguelike. Yeah, dude. Hell yeah. Yo, there's Geist. Michael Geist. Maybe he's our roommate. Yo, roomies. Got the cool mage's outfit. What if I just stand perfectly still? Oh, he probably knew we were already there because we were launching in. But yeah, I went ahead and Googled it real quick just so that I had a tab for it so I can look into it later. And yeah, saw like a few screenshots. And yeah, we mean literally a roguelike, not a roguelite, which are the games that I typically play and enjoy. But yeah, I will confess roguelikes are something I have very little experience with. So I've never played Rogue, I've never played Dwarf Fortress, I've never played... Well, Dwarf Fortress is like a... I guess you could say it's roguelike. It's more of a rogue management-like or something. I don't know, it's kind of its own special beast. I've never played, like, NetHack. There's a lot of, like, old-school rogue-like games. Like proper roguelike games that I've never played. But I definitely want to, because I've heard they're quite an experience. Yeah, it's tricky because I want to get rid of a bunch of stuff, but we're also like on the threshold of combining some things. Like, we'll combine these two down. We'll combine these two down. So, like, we're about to free up more space pretty quickly.
Welcome to this virtual training scenario. The Council of Venice would like to remind you that it takes no responsibility for accidental death, maiming, or insanity during the course of this exercise.
It's the mansion. Savage Coast.
This simulation is designed to prepare you for the pressures of a field career within the Council of Venice. Your actions will be judged and weighed, and your success will be based on your ability to remain on mission throughout.
extra murdery, like things are boarded up and scary looking, spooky looking.
Operators will adjust variables to provide a unique, tailored experience.
I'm guessing the survivors are going to be outside the house, mansion,
will be observed and cataloged. Initiating possession protocol. Watch out for
suspicious behavior. His first message is going to be probably pretty loud because it was last time, so. You know, be wary that things are going to get loud for approximately 3 seconds, probably pretty soon here. Let's seek out some survivors. Also, there's a go fast button. Oh, the door's closed. Never mind. Maybe it's like Jay's run back. Oh, I see. We got the little light blue thingamajig to say like, yay, here we go. Yay, they're right here. Yay. It's the video game thing that you do when you find something cool. You just jump around. Jump around. Jump around.
Spawn protocols engaged. Hostile entities are on the move.
I see that this is much more wide and open, which is nice because we can see the bad guys coming from a pretty good distance. Oh, you resist my bullshit, huh? You want a roughhouse, huh? Want to take a pot shot in my banana cage, Bilbo? I'm over here, like, fighting these guys. I'm like, alright, I'm doing okay. I got him down to half health after, like, expending literally all of my attacks. I'm like, yeah, I'm able to hold my own. And then Jay's like, let me just boop them on the nose.
Hostile mutator
and delete them instantly.
Activated.
Oh, I see this lady's scared. We can help them. Ah, cool. And it's most athletic. That's true, too. Yes, it's a good way to level your athleticism. Whoa, I got yeeted. Going to level your athleticism, or actually, if we're talking, elders, I know we were talking Elder Scrolls a couple days ago. If we're talking about leveling up skills, it would be acrobatics specifically. Although jumping around is one thing when it comes to acrobatics. The real way to level up your acrobatics is to like take fall damage and, you know, repeatedly snap your guys' legs. That's how I always did it in Morrowind. It was always like, how many times can I just yeet myself off the edge and presumably survive the hits? But after a while, I'll get better at not breaking my legs as much when I land, so it'll be fine. Running to a wall is for athleticism. Acrobatics is snapping your legs like a couple of twigs from jumping off of the cantons and Vivek. I was gonna say, I wonder if we're gonna summon a certain off-world devil with this conversation topic. Off-world devil's like, what's that? What's that I smell in the air? Do I hear Elder Scrolls talk? Well, Morrowind talk specifically? That's the second best way to second best way, surefire way to summon Mr. Off-World Devil. The best way by a country mile is to say,
assist the survivor.
You know, Skyrim's a pretty good game, guys. Cause then Off-World Devil like, is somebody saying something good about Skyrim? I must delete their existence. You know, I'm just fucking around. I can't help myself. I'm the same way. If someone starts talking about Bomberman 64, or it really any 3D Bomberman game, I'm gonna be like, ooh, my ears are burning. My Bomberman 64 and or Bomberman 3D senses are tingling. Breaking the egg. Yeah, that's what we do. That's what we do as in definitely Morrowind and presumably other Elder Scrolls games too. Frying your horse in Skyrim 4. Oh, destruction and restoration. Yeah, that's a legit strat too. A legit strat for it as well. I remember my first ever playthrough of Morrowind. The first playthrough I took all the way to completion, so to speak. The strat that I found, because I picked the knight class without really understanding what I was picking. I picked the knight class, which has heavy armor, long swords, some stuff that's nice and sustainable, but it also has hand-to-hand and restoration, which were a little bit tricky. So what I did is that I eventually got to a point where I was able to fight NPCs that were low enough level where they just couldn't touch me. And I figured it out. I was like trying to attack this one guy and I stopped for a second, I just noticed he was unable to touch me at all. So I just like punched the shit out of this one dude, this one like low level NPC. I didn't damage him. But I just like would smack him enough to knock him down, then kind of let him bring up his restoration a bit or his stamina a bit, and then punch him more. And of course, your hand to hand when it's low is kind of struggling. I see this
extremely aggressive hostile created.
He's extremely aggressive. I see him. He's not aggressive right now, but he'll be hopping down pretty soon, I'm pretty sure. Oh, he's pulling the strings. He's the puppet master. Anyway, yeah, so I leveled up hand-to-hand combat with, like, over the course of, like, a half an hour, just punching this one NPC repeatedly. And then I eventually killed him, but, like, just punching the shit out of him. And I think restoration was more of kind of a long-form thing. Oh, some Revenant's lore. Nice. Didn't think we'd be finding lore here. That's pretty dope. I see you up there, Mr. Magic Man. So yeah, you could fry your horse, yeah. In Skyrim, your horse wouldn't- Oh, your horse won't so your horse reports you to the town guard, that's awesome. Or, maybe the horse isn't reporting you, but maybe the lore is that somebody hears the neighing of your horse in duress.
Possession in progress.
But I like the idea more that your horse goes to tell the guards, like, hey,
new waves of hostiles have arrived. Protect the survivors.
Okay, there's the loud message. Broken is exactly, yeah, your hands don't get damaged, it's easy to farm, and your hands are magic weapons. I mean, it's pretty nuts, and I didn't know that at first with my first ever character, but it was definitely an experience, to say the least. The chickens would report your crimes? Yeah, I always thought, like, with the whole chicken thing, that was just other people seeing or observing your murdering of them. I didn't think it was actually the chickens themselves reporting your crimes. Arrested for chicken crimes. Let's heal our friend. I'm guessing if we don't heal them, they either die or, like, turn into zombies or something. Because we're not, like, healing their HP, it's like we're healing their anxiety or something. Look at this guy's dashing red outfit. So fancy.
Spawning enhanced hostile.
You can punch ghosts to death, it's true. Ghosts, Dagoths, Daedra, you name it, man, nothing's immune. Gauntlets would be a you would think. I know there are mods that add that into the scheme of things. Same with, like, beast races, like with their claw punches, that kind of thing. I guess Khajiit and Argonian specifically. There's apparently bad guys somewhere. Oh, I see. About top left. That's where Jay is. I should probably know to just stick by Jay because she knows the shit super well. ASAP. Oh, they're being possessed. Oh, interesting. Okay, so that's what that means. It means they're being possessed. We got you, homie. Yeah, so that's what it says when we're helping them. We're not killing them, but we're exorcising their demons. Yeah, the animation is different. Yeah, no, I was just saying, I know there's mods that add that into the fray, but yeah, vanilla does not give a shit about that. Vanilla, it's all samesies. And the only thing that impacts it is your hand-to-hand skill level and, I guess, strength. Whenever I think of games where I'm still thinking about how Jay was like, yeah, what you do is when you're just chilling is that you just jump a whole bunch, especially if there's something you want to show to somebody. I was thinking about how when me and my friends used to play this game, there were a lot of times where we'd be
subroutine activated.
We'd be waiting around for something. Maybe somebody would be watching a cutscene or somebody would be reading some lore that one of us would have already collected, one of us would have already seen the cutscene, so we'd be like, one person would be doing something, or maybe just taking a restroom break, or some kind of BRB would be happening. So the rest of the group would just be chilling, and sometimes we'd just chat amongst ourselves, sometimes we'd be, you know, checking our phones, but other times it'd be like, ooh, what can I, like, find something to stand on? Like, ooh, can I, like, jump in this tree somehow? Like, we'd look for just shit to stand on, and we invented this idea of a game. It's called Standing on Things, : the game, and the way to play the game is to find things that are interesting and stand on them, and the more interesting the thing is, the more points you gain, and the person who stands on the most interesting thing successfully wins. Activated. And you have to, like, actually succeed standing on it, not like, oh, I touched it, that counts it. I was like, no, you have to be rooted into the ground, and people have to see you and go, hey, that's cool, how'd you get up there? So it's like a game within a game. We came up with this all on our own, and here I am, I'm saying it on a live stream in front of 12 lovely people, according to the view count at least, and, you know, perhaps putting ourselves in a vulnerable state where they could steal our genius game development idea. But there it is. Yeah, standing on things, calling the game. Keep an eye out for it on Steam. It's going to take the world by storm. Also, I just noticed the drone over here. That's interesting. Can I talk to him? What does he do, I wonder?
Large hostile specimen spawned.
He's
be prepared.
Constructor. Be prepared. I'm prepared. Is there a big boy? Oh, there's a big boy! fuck him up. Oh, his little healing buddy. Yeah, that's what he's doing. I see. Oh, I think he did. He just delete. Oh no, that was Jay. I was like, holy shit, he just delete that guy. No, that was Jay taking out the fucking wings to murder that fucker.
Initiating reward protocol. Shutting down world simulation. Shutting down reality simulation.
Yeah, Jay's got the cool. She's got the bright angel wings on that, which I think means she went like the good path all the way, as opposed to me, who went the fucking villainous evil path like a degenerate. Tune today was the name of that achievement. Hell yeah. Thank you once again to Jay for leading me through that. That was awesome. That was awesome, and I now have what I need to combine a few things. Whoops. Combine a few things down. Let's get this used in with this guy. Kaboop. And then get this one maxed out. Actually, we can probably take it to 20, can't we? We can. And with that, I can do this. Oh, wait. I want to retrieve this one first, don't I? Because this one has more pips. So recover that guy. Oh, actually, hold on, let me do this. Use that one to this puppy. The puppy has been fused. That's a sentence, alright. We can slap that back in there, and then we'll level that up incrementally. Which would be nifty. And then, oh, I have other things. Also collect our reward, which is, oh, we don't even get any bonus experience, but it's fine, we got a lot of experience from the stuffs. There's a blue chest. Ooh, interesting. Okay. Oh, that's what that was. That was a blue chest. Yeah, we got all buddies rescued. Poison people. We don't know anybody that just poisons people with shenanigans like that, do we? That doesn't sound like anybody we know. Who's like, yo, here's this totally normal beverage that won't murder your guy to death. I promise it'll be great. And then it's like, and then deaths happen and lulls are experienced. Yeah, I'd be down for more, Jay, for sure. Yeah, for sure. We're still pretty early on the stream, so I am faux sure down for more shenanigans. This is too many. Oh, for, yeah, 300 of those, he can make a 4-pip. Oof. That'll take a hot minute, won't it? So there's this guy. So there's hit rating. Which is a 2-pip, which is exciting. That's critical rating. Let me see, what do I have for hit ratings? I think my hit ratings are all 2-pip or more. I'm pretty sure that one is. Hit rating, that's that one definitely. I think that's a 3-pip actually. 231, that's a lot. 231. Maybe I should double check this actually. So it's the glyph. Yeah, let me recover this one. Okay, it is 2-pip. Okay, so never mind. So let me fuse this back in. I wish there was a way to check the pip count without unfusing things. I guess you can say it's confusing. So what we can go ahead and do is slap that. No, not there. Slap that there. Bloop. And yeah, I feel like I should hang on to this just because that's a distillate that's legitimately useful. Except I just have nothing to spend it on right now because I need more elementalism focuses. And eventually I'll need to. Maybe I should have been keeping hold of more hammers because we found a few hammers, but I keep wood chipping them, but maybe now is a reminder that it's worth hanging on to some of them. We did free up some spaces, though, because that was several things we combined just now, which is nifty. So, we're doing okay for now, but yeah, we'll be feeling the squeeze sooner than later, probably. Alright, let me go ahead and exit. We can reform the group with Jay. So many mods where it's like, this should have been the vanilla. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I've mentioned before that I watched this nearly 8-hour long video, not all in one sitting, obviously, but it was over the course of like a week and a half or so. I watched this 8-hour video that was called A Quick Retrospective of Morrowind, and one thing that I really appreciate about this video and the person that made it is that he spent a lot of time talking about how much, well, he talks about how much he loves the game, but talks about how he like some of his philosophies on what could have been, you know, if the development schedule had a bit more time, if things didn't get cut, if Oblivion and Skyrim were to continue the trend that Morrowind established instead of simplifying things and removing features, you know, what would the future, what could modern RPGs look like if Morrowind was allowed to really realize its initial vision. And I mean, it's of course a shoulda, coulda, woulda. You don't want to spend too much energy, mental energy, you know, languishing over the could have been, just because, you know, it's an alternate reality that we're not going to ever realize. But it was interesting to consider. It was like an interesting thought exercise on like what the Elder Scrolls series could have turned into with the ambition that Morrowind, from its like initial, you know, according to like the initial writers and the initial designers and whatnot, the vision that they had, that it really could have been a contender for like top, like best game ever awards, that kind of thing. And for me, it's one of my favorite games ever, but it could have been like
this virtual training
scenario. It could have been along the lines of like what a lot of people consider Ocarina of Time. Like Ocarina of Time is considered like the golden standard for Zelda adventure style games. Morrowind could have been like the golden standard for like PC RPGs. And it is in a lot of ways, but it's not the standard. That's the thing.
Within the Council of Venice.
Yeah, I thought the same thing, Jay. I was like, ooh, this looks like a new one. I know you said it's random each time, so. I guess this is the game trying to ask for our forgiveness after giving us the same elite dungeon 3 times in a row yesterday.
As the scenario progresses, operators will adjust variables.
I can do one layer. I can do one layer after this.
How you react, we'll do this, and then
we'll do one layer, then I'll.
And
then we'll do more story stuffies.
Initiating spectral disturbance. Piercing the veil.
But like I said, it was interesting. It was an interesting video, and like the stuff near the end where it kind of gives kind of a retrospective on, not really a what could have been, but necessarily, but like an alternate universe. Like here's like my theory on where things could have gone. Which, like I said, if nothing else, it's an interesting thought experiment. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. So we got a little bit of lore to read.
New waves of hostiles have arrived.
Ooh, there's
protect
a loud
the survivors.
Again. He's so loud. Yes, up front. Yeah, I keep forgetting that you can just check the map and it'll actually show you where bad guys are spawning in from, like which direction they're coming in from. Yeah, like right in, like right here is where they're spawning, which is nifty. Of course, it's good to smack these lads out this way as opposed to once they get inside. Once they get inside, then they'll cause harm to our buddies.
Hostile.
We got big boy. Fuck you, big boy. Blech. Just gonna not pick those up, I think. Gall abstain. Oh, I actually didn't mean to pick that up, but now I'm extra strong for 13 seconds. When there's no bad guys to fight. Oh, here we go. Oh, right. And I'm reflexively picking these up when I said I wouldn't. So I'm done with the item caches. I do want to pick up the ones that have little belts on them, because those are nifty for feeding them into our stiff, this level 21 buddy. Hell yeah. Item power 274, it's pretty good, it's pretty good. Not amazing, obviously, but we're hanging in there. Like, if we compare our item power to Jay, her item power, it doesn't actually show, but it's probably a million billion, so. Like, ours is like, yeah, 274, it's pretty good compared to where we were at. She's a 1280, good lord. Yeah, so it's like, her item power could eat our item power for breakfast, man. Oh, I see they're down. Yeah, they're probably coming through the middle. Let them try. I'm guessing more will be spawning from this
hostile
side.
Hostile mutator subroutine activated.
Mutator subroutine. Oh, here we go. So he's out of there, and it looked like there was more. I see that's leaving a nice little ectoplasm puddle. It's like a little purple friend. I'm guessing I shouldn't stand in that. Oh, there it is. I was like, I see an AoE thing happening, and I'm scared. Hey, Victoria, is 12 to the limit? That's a good question. Yeah, is there an upper bound for the item power? I guess there probably technically is. Eventually, once you have like 4 pip weapons or 5 pip weapons across all the board with like, you know, the best of the best, with all the talismans, like all of it maxed out completely. Elite 17 is 1700, okay. Is Elite 17 the top highest it goes?
Hostile mutator subroutine activated.
Oh, it's right in front of us. And Shazam! We got Stinky Pink Boy. It's good to see you, Victoria. And, I hope I'm not gonna mispronounce your name too horribly. Phaser? Or, Shazer, maybe. I'm probably goofing your name, but thank you for joining, my friend. I hope you're doing well. 1754 is the, yeah, so 1700 is, like, top of the top, and, yeah, 1754 specifically is as high as it goes, which is bonkers to imagine. Holy shit. Thank you for joining, by the way, guys. I really appreciate people tuning in to share part of your evening with me.
Hostile mutator,
always very, very nice,
activated.
And I recognize all the time that your time is very valuable, so I don't take for granted the fact that we got people here to chill with us. Makes these streams a lot more fun for me, for sure. Alright, so wave one.
Large hostile specimen spawned.
Ooh, we got the loud message. He's like, yo, we got some loud shit. Or some big shit, rather. He's up here. I see. You're not a large specimen. You're a very much normal-sized specimen. I feel lied to. Medium-sized specimen, I guess, doesn't quite hit the same. I just love the gamification of shooting this guy in the head 1,000 times, smacking him with hammers, lighting his ass on fire, and then he just falls over. It's like, oh, I'm dead now.
Initiating long-range support. Snipers will cover you.
Ooh, we got some snooper poopers. Also, Dave, good to see you, buddy. How you doing, Mr. Dave? Also, I saw the message in the Discord server that you were doing more streamy streams tonight. How did the mass effecting go? Because it's a little, it's not self-promotion, it's unself. Promotion, in my case at least. I can tell you that not female, that's my friend Dave in the chat. He's doing some Mass Effect streamy strams lately in preparation for the legendary remake.
Spawn protocols engaged.
That's happening fairly
soon.
Hostile
entities are on the move.
He's going through all three games. I don't know if he's going to be streaming all three of them, but he's playing through all three of them. And he's streaming a whole bunch of Mass Effect times. So if you like Mass Effect and you want a chill dude to tickle your eardrums with his sultry tones, then follow that man. He's a good dude.
Spawning enhanced.
He's a good old
hostile.
Friend of mine from the good old LAN party days, man. We go back quite a bit, and he's a good guy. And also, I selfishly want him to. I want more of my friends to stream, so I have a very selfish interest as well. So it's like, ooh, if more people follow him and encourage him to stream, then I'll have more friends I can raid and more friends I can harass and shitpost on their streams. So, you know, lovingly harass and lovingly shitpost, of course. Yeah. Yeah, I don't want Dave to think I'm doing this for his sake. I definitely have some selfish ulterior motives here. Well, it's so loud. Yeah, only certain messages are like really loud, and then other messages are totally normal. And because I have the dialogue slider maxed out, and usually it's pretty chill. But every once in a while, for very specific scenarios, we'll get like big loud, like this guy has so much to say. Had a power. Oh no! I'm sorry to hear that, Dave. I'm sure that was frustrating. That shit's never funsies. Oh, big boy, we got Demon Lad, hell yeah. Hell spawn. Hex spawn. He's fucking dead, hell yeah. It's been a good outlet. Yeah, exactly. No, that's exactly how I feel, man. I'm
spawning enhanced hostile.
I'm very grateful to have a hobby like streaming that is always something that I can look forward to, something that feels productive. I mean, I guess I'm producing content in that sense, but like it's like a project that I'm always working on. I'm always looking for something for stuff that I can improve, looking for things I can add to the stream, or new games I can play, or features I can add into the stream, or channel point redemptions, or just stuff like that. Like, it's a ongoing project for me, so it feels like a pet project that I can always contribute to, and it's fun, and it involves video games, which I'm always passionate about, and it gives me a chance to socialize with friends and make new friends, of course. So yeah, there's so many things that streaming I have to thank when it streaming for when it comes to enriching my life over the past, well, several years, but this past year in particular, it's been very helpful. I really have a hard time imagining what going through quarantine would be like without some kind of outlet, some kind of like thing I could contribute to. Like a fun pet project thing, because otherwise I would have work, which is, you know, I don't hate my job, but it's not exactly the most fulfilling thing ever. You know, it pays the bills. I'm not horrible at it, I like to think. I tell myself I'm not horrible at it. That might be, you know, a bold-faced lie, but It's, you know, it's, but I don't spawning like eat, breathe, and live self-development. It's like, yeah, it's, you know, it's a job. It's a job. My coworkers are pretty cool. You know, it's like I'm fairly fortunate in that sense, but it's not like, oh man, I need this. So I remember reading not too terribly long ago that a good exercise that we can all take on from time to time, myself included, is to take a moment to consider if your financial situation stayed exactly where it was right now. So if you were granted a magic wand that says, I will summon your paycheck as it is right now every 2 weeks, or once a month, or once a week, however frequently you get a paycheck, I will continue your current paycheck as it is right now, without any additional expenses. That can, well, with the same expenses too. So with the same, you know, cost for groceries, that kind of thing. So it's like your financial situation stays exactly the same,
boss,
and you don't have to
spawn.
Work. What do
adjusted
you do to
survival
fill your time?
Chance?
And that can be a hard question to answer. I don't know if I have a singular answer. There's a lot of things I would want to do with my time. Streaming would be one of them, but there's several things I would want to do. But the idea is like, yeah, what would you do to fill out your time with to like be fulfilling? Because on the one hand, it sounds nice to say, oh, I play video games all day, but it's like, well, if I'm just like playing games, I'm not like building anything, I'm not creating something. Because the idea of creating something is a fulfilling
protocol.
Exercise usually.
Shutting down world simulation.
So
shutting down,
it's like, what's something that I can produce or create or work on that gives me that sense of fulfillment? That that just consuming a hobby doesn't necessarily do. I mean, playing video games is fun, but it doesn't necessarily, like, for me at least, doesn't necessarily like scratch all those itches. So, like I said, it's just an interesting like little thought exercise, and I don't have the answers necessarily. But it allows for some interesting kind of self-reflections and such. Also, level 14 of that bad boy, hell yeah. Brought us up by 3 item power points. Love to see it. And a little smidge bit on that one too.
Critical empowerment.
Ooh, level 15
results.
Which means 270. Oh, 7. Okay, so it stayed the same. Oh, I'm sorry to hear it storming where you're at, Victoria. It rained here a whole bunch yesterday, and a little bit today. Not quite as much today, but a whole bunch yesterday. And I know that other places have gotten some freezing rain and some storms. So I know it's been kind of silly lately. Let us skedaddle out of this cool little place. Computer hardware, yeah. That's exactly it. Yeah, some hobbies, of course, are kind of tricky. But I mean, I guess that's the thing, though. Like, you're still getting some kind of income. You know, you're still getting the ability to pay for them. Sometimes they have to save up for them, obviously. Yeah, the NAS, yeah, exactly. That is a cool toy. It sounds like a cool toy, at least. So yeah, the idea is that you would still be getting income, it'd just be the same income. Because one thing I hear from people whenever, or I shouldn't say I hear from people, but one of the things I've observed from people when this exercise comes up is people will say, oh, I'll travel a whole bunch. And it's like, no, see, traveling is expensive. Or at least, I think it's expensive, personally. I mean, I know of a few people that are like, oh yeah, I'm going to like Europe to like go backpacking for 3 months. And it's like, how do you afford that? I really don't know. And this is not to say that I'm like looking down on that, like, oh, those peasants or those dilettantes, you know, to society. No, I think it's cool as hell. I just literally don't know how you afford that just because that's very expensive. Like, just, oh, let me just travel to Europe and like, I literally don't know how to do that. But if you can find a way to work for you, more power to you. But for the most part, traveling and vacationing is expensive. So it's like, it's not so much what would I do if I had endless resources. It's more, it's like if my resources stayed the same and my time was more fleshed out or flexible, really. What would I do to fill the time? 10 drive stuff. Oh, man, that sounds awesome. Different purposes. Dave, you got such a badass setup, man. That sounds so fucking cool. I have a couple friends that are like really into that kind of stuff too, Dave. And I admire it deeply. Like, I admire that kind of technical know-how, that kind of skill set, because it requires a lot of different knowledge. I mean, I'm a software guy, but and again, I like to think I'm like okay with software development, but dude, I'm a fucking dingus. I'm the biggest dumbass on the planet when it comes to a lot of hardware stuff, networking stuff. I mean, dude, you couldn't find a person who knows less about networking than my shitty little ass. So, needless to say, oh, that's cool. There's a little drone friend. Needless to say, that's just really cool and distracting. That's something that I do admire about you, Dave. The fact that you have such a interesting and like well-versed skill set with cool shit like that. And of course, I know it's not something you've attained overnight. I know this is something you've like done through work for a number of years. So these are things you acquire over time. We got Taika, hell yeah. We got I remember Niana. Yeah, I remember Niana. We played with her not too terribly long ago. And I think Bijevs is the person that was in the chat earlier. Hell yeah, we got multiple friends in the chat. Can you fix my yeah? How do you set the timer on the VCR? Hey man, I went to college for 4 years to learn how to do a bunch of like, you know, cool software development-y things. I would need at least another 4 years to learn how to like, you know, program microwaves and change the clock on a VCR. That's like the master's degree level shit. I'm just one little bachelor's degree kind of scrub over here, man. My bachelor degree powers are limited. Yo, he's got the bunny mask. Hell yeah, he's got the bunny mask. Kind of like a secret agent kind of aesthetic. I'm digging it. Recognize? Yeah, they're sneaky. I was gonna say I recognize sneaky. Let's see, is there anything that I want to put in the bank? Oh, there's stuff I would like to put in, but I have limited spaces. Oh, also, I could put something in here. I just realized. Oh, never mind. I already have the signet in there. Never mind. I have a signet there. Signet there, and of course a signet there. So, okay, so yeah, we're good there. So, just to be clear, shattering, let's look at what we have. Oh, also, I need to go to the raid group. Whoops. Raid. There we go. Raid, Shadow Legends. Alright, guys. You know I'm not a huge mobile gamer, but I've been playing this cool game called Bachelor Degree. Microwave Management. Dude, I would have taken the shit out of a course that was like all about meme shit. Like, yeah, man, here's how you change VCR's timer, or clock, rather. Programming microwaves, yeah. Yeah, what if I'm in the office? I mean, well, granted, I'm not in the office a lot now, obviously, with COVID times, but what if some point in the future I'm in the office and I'm like, I'm in an emergency microwave situation, and Alex, you're the only one that can save us. One of the, like, is it the red wire or blue wire situation, and I can't figure out how to program the microwave, and I end up killing us all. What if that happens? And I'm ill-prepared for it. Gosh. It's scary to think about, honestly. Alright, so yeah, what were we saying? We got, so shattering, devastation, time and space alteration, and nemain. So any out of all those things, we also have laceration, bludgeoning, thirst. Oh, I'm a thirsty boy. Weakness, overwhelming power, agility, condensed anima, manic. Yeah, thirst. Was thirst something I already had? Thirst is up here, right? Yeah, there's thirsty. When we're feeling it, when we got the thirst. Time and space alteration. That's the one we already have that on something else, right? The blue one. Yeah. So we would need this. We need another one of these to make another blue, which could then get maxed out to combine on this guy to make it purple. What if it was purple? What's something else I can do? Whee! Now, you know, here's something I could do. I could just go ahead and motherfucking, like, just deadass buy a hammer. I could just go into the auction house, be like, yo, fam, hit me with your shittiest standard quality hammer. I guess I could start with not standard. Yeah, well, yeah, what about superior? Break it down for me. So we could get like a, you know, a decent one of these friends. In fact, yeah, what if I get just a big old pinky boy? What if I just go right for the pinky boys? Yeah, what if I say give me the epic shit? Oh, it's expensive. Shocking absolutely nobody, that shit's expensive. Not even, like, looking for pip count, necessarily. Like, I would take, you know, the shittiest one, honestly, but Yeah, Frostbound Hammer. I mean, this is some spanky fancy shit. But if I were to go back to Superior, yeah, I mean, you can see the cost differential is almost non-existent. I mean, I could just get this one for 2,000 and just, like, just a thing to combine into, so who fucking cares, right? If I were to go for these, though, like, the one I have right now is the Fuming Despoiler of Havoc, which is pretty good. It's pretty good. Crit damage, critical healing. Rage-consuming abilities do more damage and near my enemies, so that's nice. That gives you Juggernaut abilities and Rock Hard and Die Hard abilities. That's nifty. Tenderizer of Recovery. Incoming heals. That's nice. It's okay. When you hit an enemy with an ability, a hammer ability, you get a nifty little buff. 30 seconds. Yeah, so there's some cool ones here. There's a Mangler. Your crit power is increased by 9%, and you get more protection. I'm tempted to just buy this thing whole ass. Partial ass? Whole ass. Maybe I should hold off a little bit longer, though, just to be safe. Just because, would it be group? No, it's raid, yeah. I'm in the right section. Yeah, we've got a little bit more wiggle space. Not a ton of wiggle space is the tricky thing, though. Let me close out of this. So, let me reopen this puppy right here. Let's see, I think... all these are things I need to turn in at some point. In the museum, and it's tricky just because it requires a lot of anime shards, but I have a lot of anime shards, so I just need to go through and knock that out at some point really soon. Yeah, we're about to combine these down. Are there any purple things I'm going to be leveling up pretty soon? Not really. That one's getting there, but we don't have a blue that I can combine it into, so we'll need yet another head talisman for that one. This one's got a bit, this one's got a bit. This one's it's going to be the quickest one. And it'll take a while. So yeah, there's no immediate, it's not like we're going to be doing a nice little combination type of deal very soon. Oh, look at this guy spinning around. Oh, that's Niana. Yeah. That's Niana, who we'll be playing with shortly. Everyone's so fast. Look how fast everyone is. Man, oh man. So fucking cool. I like the skull bike. Dude, that's dope. Very, Ghost Rider? Is that the name of that superhero? Very Ghost Rider-esque. We got Gator Boy, we got Azrael. We got Summer, Toshiro. Oh, Toshiro, Kimbra. Hell yeah. We got some new faces, some new screen names that I don't recognize. Actually, that's not true. I recognize the screen name Azrael. Where have I seen that name before? I think I might have seen the name in game at one point. But yeah, Summer is new, or new to me at least. Toshiro, Kimbra, Gator Boy, hell yeah. Down for some new friendos. Hello. Yeah, so what I'll just do is when we get down to it, I'll just be getting rid of some of these distillates that I don't need. In fact, I might even just look for some of the lesser ones that I can go ahead and discharge. There's 3,000, 3,000, 2,800, 3,000. So let me get rid of the weakest links. 29, 29, 29. There's a 28. Get rid of a few of these 28s. I think it was this one, yeah. Get rid of a few of those. Just free up a few more inventory slots. Good stuff. Good stuff. Time for the meetup. You got it. Let's get on over there. Slapping into hell, and I'm guessing this will be an elite dungeon. So we'll have to... Oh, wait. It's a lair. What am I doing? Yeah, it's a lair, not a dungeon. And let me think. What will this be? This is the Savage Coast. I can't remember what the Savage Coast lair is. We've done it before, but I'm blanking on the name or on the area. It'll be, oh yeah, just the little kind of bog areas, yeah. When I think Savage Coast, I think of the Hell region near the Overlook Motel. I think the amusement park, that whole deal. Let's grab some stuff. This one too. And of course, I will need to put the Death from Above quest on hold, but that's fine. All right. Always got the cool, always got the Ricky Pagan pants, hell yeah. Instance full, okay, so we'll have to go ahead and say yes for a new instance then. Get a different loading screen. I mean, it's still the same area, obviously, but. Kinda nifty. Excuse me. Alright, we got Niana. Oh, she's got a cool little hoverboard. Also, I like how her character's last name is Descartes. Is it Descartes or Descartes? Or Descartes, maybe. Oh, right, we gotta warp. Over. Oh, I'm like way back this way. There we go. Yeah, we got Pichevs. Hell yeah. We're assembling the squad. There's Kimbra. Looks like Kimbra's like, it's like a, yeah, she's got the bathrobe and the bunny slippers. She's like, oh, I'm just getting out of bed. Time to kill some zombies. I like the menacing aura of like having these like arcing lightning bolts while being in a bathrobe and just chilling. Implying that she's at like 1% of her power. Like, yeah, I'm just gonna kill some zombies to help wake myself up. You know, it's my version of drinking coffee. I was admiring this, I was admiring Azrael's badass outfit. I just love Ricky Pagan. He's such a fun character, dude. One of my favorite NPCs in the entire goddamn game. Yo, there's Tycoon. We've played with her before. Hell yeah. Looks like we are complete and assembled. To take the detonators. Like. And of course, there's a lot of detonators to be found. I think we have to find like 10 or 15 per group, so it's like a total of, well, twice, basically twice whatever the requirement is. Because each group will need a whole bunch. Just trying to keep up, there's a lot of stuff going on. Here we go, more detonators. Yeah, 3 out of 10, yeah. Oh, detonators, but also explosives, right? So there's a lot of things to pick up between those two objectives. Thankfully, if a member of a group picks it up, it goes to all members of that group. But there's two groups, so again, that's why we gotta, like, for the whole raid party, we have to do it twice. And everything nice. Nothing there. I'm trying to keep an eye out on the ground for stiff. Oops. Okay. All right, very good. All right, that one's being picked up. Good, good, good. Yeah, as long as it's being picked up. As long as it's being accounted for. Trying to keep an eye on the AoEs because they will be brutal. It probably won't kill us in one hit, but they will be rather gnarly. Because what's likely to happen is that we'll get the achievement, or not the achievement, but the threshold. We're killing all the bad guys very easily, but then it'll take us a lot longer to get all the pickups for both groups. Almost committed too deeply for that one. Got the detonator over there. Ooh, excuse me. Goodness. I'm a gross son of a bitch. I'm just like running up to bad guys and they're dying before I can even whip out the hammer. Before I can whip it out. It's a good problem to have when you've got like a full squad of super badass high level players who really know this game super well. Dynamite. So that gives us 10 dynamite lads. I just need two more detonators, or we rather. This group I'm in needs two more detonators. There's multiple J's, oh man. As if one J wasn't powerful enough. Yeah, I think that's a chaos ability that like multiplies your dude. Your dude or your dudette. Another one complete. I think all I have left is the spring. The group one, that is. Up to 7. Damn, that's a lot. Also, that jacket on Summer is badass. Check that shit out, dude. It's like, what's it say? Killing spree? Killing something. Yeah, I like it. Whatever it says, it's dope as hell. But yeah, up to 7 copies, though. That's impressive. So that'd be a total of 8 J's, which would be a lot. It's a lot to handle. Let's see what that jacket says. Oh, Monster Hunter. Okay, cool. It says killing machine. It says killing machine. It's dope as fuck is what it says. That's what I'm saying it says. Oh, that's when you kill the champions, you get a dope-ass jacket, yes. Kind of like with the lair bosses and the bone jacket we have. Whoop. Yeah, because to me, the Monster Hunter achievement, that jacket implies that somebody has like gone really out of the way to kill all the champion monsters. They've like sought out a bunch of stuff in the main game, sought out a lot of like high power monsters, and of course killed them, but took the time and energy to hunt them all down properly. Whereas the jacket I have, where you kill all the lair bosses, means one of two things. Either one, means you're incredibly high level and badass, or two, in my case, it means you've been scrubbing it up and you've been leaning very heavily on some very high level players to run your ass through these things, and that is exactly what I've been doing. And these very nice people we've been playing with, they have indeed been running my ass. Just my ass, but definitely running my ass through a bunch of these layers. Because there's no way I'd be able to pull these things off myself without the help of high level players. Because yeah, I do have some friends that I used to play this game with back in the day, and they've picked it up a little bit, but none of us really play like super consistently for multiplayer content, at least. With the exception of being the streams I've been doing lately, obviously, but like on the whole, none of us really play consistently enough, so none of us are particularly high level. So yeah, like there'd just be no way I'd be able to form a group organically. I would have to seek out the high level badass players. Yeah, because group one is 3 for 3. That's right, yeah. So we need just the group two status report. Of course, we're seeing more detonator spawns, so there's stuff to be picked up. I saw somebody pick up something just now, so it seems like there's still more to be done. The 3 for 3? Cool beans. That hoverboard's so dope. I think that's one that like you can turn invisible so that monsters can not detect you. Like all those bad boys, got its lots of nifty little pointy renos. In fact, I should do this. Down to fitty fitty. So I don't get fucking exploded. Unlock that one, and then, oh, I'm like 7 points short on that one. That's fine though. Here's my blood. There it is. Big ghosty friend. Not really ghosty, but big spooky friend. Whoops. He yeeted me. That's not very nice. Very good. Okay. Stuck with the hammer in hand. There we go. This little guy. This is a little Phil Fector friend. Of all the lair bosses I've seen, this might be the least threatening one. I mean, he's, you know, a scary lad stats-wise, but visually he's not quite as scary as the big boys.
Critical
empowerment, you love to see it. That to this fella. Two of them to that fella, yes. Then of course a bunch of Signet stuff. This is riot control for shotgun stuff, cool. Hell yeah. Oh, heck yeah. Oh, she was, I think she was talking to Summer. We need to wait for, right? Are we good? Oh yeah, okay, yeah, Summer's coming back. Yeah, it happens, it happens, it happens, it happens to the best of us. Lord knows I've pulled some embarrassing shit. Far be it from me to pass judgment. So we'll power this, actually not this guy, this guy. Boink. And this one's level 19, that one's getting pretty close. Unsurprisingly, I'm getting up there with the Signet Destilates. Oh, okay, now we're on group 2. Oh, Taika died. Shouldn't we wait for Taika? Yeah, the right control one, I'll probably toss it or just mix it in with another Signet if we can find one. Oh, he's dead. I was like still attacking like an idiot. He's very much dead. The deadest of dead. Oh, not you. Over here. Blood rites, which I think is gonna be blood magic specifically. It do be that way. For neck talismans, of course, we have one for elementalism. It's like, oh man, I was taking a drink. It's like, let me make sure I don't pull the same shenanigans where I get bodied by the weakest boss. Crack it open. This time it's more distillates. Very good. Oh, we lost two. You're right. Yep. We'll get Gator Boy and Summer in here. Oh, more crafting victims. It happens. It happens to the best of us, man. That's just how it do sometimes. It do be that way sometimes. Like I should just waste these. Yeah, I'm just gonna waste. I feel a little bad. Oh, you can't delete Signets? Oh. Maybe I can't like right now. Maybe later I can. Maybe you have to merge them. That's interesting. Or sell them, maybe. There's some big AoEs from this guy. This guy's a little bit spicier. A little bit spicier, not the slightest bit nicer. Oh, he's dead, okay. No death that time, though. Hell yeah. Heck yeah! Cannot delete signets. Interesting. So you have to sell them, I guess. Or sell them or... Yeah. Interesting stuff. Yes, thank you. Thank you. Thank you to Jay for leading us through the duo scenarios that we did earlier. And thank you again, as always, to Jay and everyone else for running us through the lair, which is always really cool to see. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, very much agreed. Thank you to Jay for organizing all that, because she always does such a good job of bringing in lots of cool peeps for us to play with. Yeah, I'm sad I can't delete those. That's kind of unfortunate. So how's about this? I guess I could sell them. I guess I could, like... What I will do... What I definitely will do is I'll just get rid of all the blue little dudes. The blue friends. So get rid of those. Let's keep that one, because that's legitimately useful. Grab as much as I can. Yeah, get rid of these. And then find other things to slap into here, so that gets this friend. So that's almost a 17, which is pretty good. We're past the halfway point leveling that guy, which is nice. That goes to you. Bloop. 15, very good. Still the same two for that. Got almost all of them. Hey, there's Swords Guy. What's up, buddy? Thank you very much to Swords Guy for that raid. How are you doing, my dude? It's good to see you, friend. How was your stream, my friend? We'll give our boy a quick little shout out. There we go. There we go. Let's see what he was doing. Doing some Pokemon Red Blue. Are we talking some Nuzlocke challenge? I know you were doing, I think it was you, were doing some Nuzlocke stuff not too terribly long ago. It's good to see you, Swords Guy, and I hope you're doing well, and thank you again for that very nice raid. It's good to see you, buddy. And thank you for sharing your very kind and chill community with us. We're playing some more Secret World Legends, of course. It's a game I've been playing a lot of lately, although we're nearing the end of it, believe it or not. So within the next stream or two, we'll be wrapping it up and going to something else, which is exciting. Good to see you, buddy. Yeah, how'd it go? And also, what kinds of Pokemon shenanigans were you doing today? If it was like a ROM hack or like some Nuzlocke shenanigans? Because I know that the... Oh, also, I think I just sit on this one for a while because I think I need to... Oh, no, I don't. Never mind, I'm full of shit. We merge that with, this is crit power rating, we can merge that with, which of these has crit power? You have it, yes. So we can fuse that with this to make more numbers, yes, more numbers. Yes, 281, hell yeah, look at our numbers slowly increase. We're becoming too powerful. A sign of a true RPG when you're slowly and incrementally increasing your numbers so that you can have more numbers and make those numbers sexier. Just how we do it, man. 17, 282, yep, look at our item power slowly going up, little by little. Yeah, can't delete those. We could probably just sell them, though. Let's do this. Let's go back to Agartha. Teleport. Anyway, yeah, doing some Nuzlocke. That's awesome, man. Oh, the Nuzlocke is over. Oh, shit. So, just to be clear, that's 1-0 in your favor, right? So, you've nailed it. Dude, Nuzlocke is no shit, man. Nuzlocke's some hard shit. I've never played it myself. But I've watched... So, I like Demon Morph Suit with little bunny slippers. That's... They're ice skates. Or they're, like, future skate things. I don't know. I'm not sure exactly what's going on there. But they're like little floaty skates. That's cool. I thought they were bunny slippers. There we go. But yeah, just to be clear, yeah, the Nuzlocke stuff, I've never played it myself, but I've watched it a whole bunch, and they're entertaining to watch, but they can get stressful. 7 games to go, baby. Yeah, so you did Pokemon Red Blue. I'm guessing next up is... Well, wait, 7 games or 7 generations? Also, Bree, good to see you. Thank you for that is a good email, by the way. I like is that the Pride Wave? That's a good moat. Yeah, that's a good moat. Good stuff. Let me sell some of these things. Sell the Blood Rites. Sell the Riot Control. Get it out of here. not to say that it's bad or useless, it's just not really what I'm about. Can I sell the distillates that I'm not gonna use? Be pretty cool if I could, but I don't think that they have a monetary value, so they cannot be sold. Yeah, I'll just toss it. Give us more inventory spaces back. Inventory real estate is very important. Actually, I wonder, can I like fuse them together? No, can I do that one? Nope. Okay, so I was wondering if there was like any cool way I can combine them to free up some space, but there's no such thing for that. Also, an entire watermelon. Yes, I'd like to buy one watermelon, please. So I could throw it at a demon and have it get mad at me and shit my pants. So I'll just go back to South Africa shenanigans to continue the main story. A cheer. Okay, yeah, 7 generations in. So yeah, next is gold, silver. Awesome, bud. Well, can I ask what the squad was, Swords Guy? What your ending squad was? Once you beat the Elite Four in red, I guess? Or blue, whoever the ultimate bad guy was? Oh, excuse me. Wrath of the Dawn, yes. So we have to take a seat right over here. Wait for our handler to come through. Except there's some side quests I want to do first. Let's do some side questy times before we do main questy times. Get level 20, hell yeah, Victoria! Yeah, I remember you saying that it was taking forever to level. Which is frustrating. Here, I can use it from here. There we go. Let me get back to our bunk. There's a way over this way. Actually, no, it's not going to be this way. It's going to be... yeah, further this way. Into the anointed sections.
Have you become anointed?
Welcome.
Oh wait, no, I had the right idea. It is this path. This is the main road. At Jolteon, Fearow, Lapras, Snorlax. Dude, wow. Gyarados, Nidoqueen. That's a fucking dope, like, hashtag squad goals, man. That sounds awesome. Welcome. I was gonna say that's delightfully OP and I love it. Yeah, that's the thing. You kind of gotta bust out the big guns because the Elite Four ain't no shit, man. So, no shame whatsoever in busting out the big guns for those big boys and girls.
Welcome.
So our bunk is, I can't remember exactly, because we can't just go here, can we? That's to the favored sections. Yeah, we can't do that necessarily. I think our bunk was over this way. Hey, must be the money. You had an original party member make it to the end. Now that's impressive. As I know with Nuzlocke, it's, you know, they faint once and it's donezo. That is easier said than done, but that's impressive. The remaining original member. I figured that's what you meant. Yeah, like not by choice. I'm sure there were probably some you lost where you were like, oh, that hurts. But like I said, yeah, it's a badass squad at the end, dude. Who do you think your starter is going to be for gold, silver? Do you already kind of have a game plan, or are you going to like just take it as it comes, just YOLO that shit when the time happens? I'm going to do some more side quests, like I said, before we accept the main quest or continue the main quest. I got some side questy. I got the itch for the side quest. Going to do. Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, have the fans choose it. Hell yeah, dude. If it were up to, I'll ask it this way. If it were up to you, who would your, let me go and leave the raid, there we go. If it were up to you, who would your starter be? And honestly, there is no wrong answer, I'm just curious. I'm not gonna be like one of those like, Cyndaquil, like I'm down for anything. They're all awesome. Just go random. I respect it, I respect the random choices. I was gonna say, I know you're pretty well versed when it comes to Pokemon shenanigans, so I'm sure you've seen them all the way through. Oh, these demon hyenas are not hard to fight necessarily. They're sometimes just annoying. Like, these are a lot easier than some of the monsters we fought in Tokyo, although we've increased our item power quite a lot thanks to, the assistance of Jay and several other people who have run us through high-level dungeons and raids that I wouldn't be able to play through otherwise, so that probably has had something to do with it. Something to do with me being able to, like, have more item power and fight these guys with a little bit more comprehensive, like, a little bit more confidence. Like, I probably wouldn't be that close to one-shotting those guys otherwise. Cyndaquil's good. Yeah, honestly, they're all good, but Cyndaquil is... I mean, I just love the design for Cyndaquil. It's very delightful and adorable. Oh, hell yeah. Puzzle One knows the good shit, too. Absolutely. Oh, that sounds cute as hell. That sounds wonderful. Yeah, Cyndaquil's good. That's a good choice. In addition to being adorable, it's just a solid poke. Solid mon. I like how the one in front of us didn't get yeeted, but the guy behind him did. I gotta kill four more. Try to do the flashbang ability, which more just looks weird. It doesn't actually stun us, but it just looks disorienting. There we go. Two left. Who else wants some? There's one. Here's two. And you! Cool, there it is. So now, as I was saying, there is a side quest I was en route to acquiring. And acquire it I shall. In fact, we started it, but then We were brought in for some cool shit, so I want to do the cool shit first. Except that one, yeah, we gotta find a way to get the flying demon lad's attention. I will go ahead and toss that. What? You can't delete that item? Why can't I delete these things? What in the world? You just can't delete some things now. Can't delete that. What's going on? I can't delete things. That's weird. Can I delete these? I can delete those. Interesting. Have I never been able to delete those? I always assumed that I could. But what am I doing? Because, like, if I were to say boop and then boop, yeah, it won't let me assemble. It's like, what do? I guess, yeah, after a certain point, you just have to sell them, I guess. It's unfortunate. Anyway, what am I doing? Yeah, we're leveling this guy up. Almost to 18. Very good. Defense rating, we'll give that to this one. And that is it. But yeah, if I'm like, I'm gonna hang on to extra focuses and things for weapons that I can't use, then that's kind of a bummer. Alright, so we're looking over here. Yeah, we need some kind of way to get this monster's attention. Also, I found some lore. Two items for the bestiary. So for the demon hyenas, the Kishi. They have a human face, the better to charm, to woo, and to lure. On the back of its head, the Kishi has a hyena face, the better to rend you. Teeth like steel and jaws like a vise. Nothing breaks free from the Kishi's bite. There is no sneaking up on a Kishi. They're always facing you, it says. Yeah, the hyena demons. We also got some Revenant lore from earlier, which completed our Revenant lore, actually, oddly enough. Seeing a revenant is an ill omen. They are drawn to areas where disasters, natural and human-made, are imminent. They proved instrumental in spreading the plague of history, the bubonic plague, smallpox, typhus, and the measles. With their dark hoods and their sharp blades, many have mistaken them for the Grim Reaper. The revenants gather, sweetling. The number of their sightings increase exponentially around the world. Dark days are here, it says. Yeah, that's some 2021 energy right there for sure. So there's the scanner. Oh, not the scanners. I guess the air horns, right? Or air horns, the sirens. Would it be the scanner?
Checking for current point total. You are a foundling.
I mean, they say I'm a foundling, but I feel like I'm fancy. There's one right there. Something to get their attention. There's like a bottle rocket, or if I could somehow sound the sirens, the air horns. Also, whenever I'm fighting a flying thing and I'm able to launch them with the eruption skill, that's always kind of silly. Looking for something I can use. Yeah, I was thinking it'd be these lads. Check out this big red boy. What? Wait, you get out of here. Get down here and fight me, you fool. Of course, I slowed him, though. I slowed his movements. Got his ass. Let's keep looking. Yeah, it's not the sirens. Also, I don't know if I've never fought Blood Talon, and I kind of want to. He's very big and red and scary. But I want to fuck him up, so I shall fuck him up. Would that be too low to leave the Savage Coast? I wouldn't think so. I don't think there's any level requirements to leave. Well, let me think about that. I mean, 20 seems not. I mean, 20 seems like to be pretty high for Kingsmith. For the secondary in Kingsmith, I think. Is it saying that you're unable to leave the Savage Coast? Oh, you can leave, but should you? I think you could if you wanted. There's areas in Blue Mountain I would probably recommend against being in right now. Just because there are some high-level areas that will be kind of spicy. But you could if you wanted to, for sure. Cannot delete that item. It's so weird that, yeah, you just can't delete certain things.
Critical empowerment results.
Yeah, if nothing else, I could always just dead-ass buy that hammer. You know what, Mia? I think I'm gonna go ahead and go for it. I was joking about it earlier. Weapon. Hammer. Superior, right? It's the lowest of the lowest. Yeah, give me the cheapest shit you got.
The screens are not screens. Do not
alright. Oh, right, we have to retrieve it. Okay, that's fine. We'll do that in a bit. I forgot about that little detail. You have to retrieve it first. Minor issue. Alright, so anyway, so that was Blood Talon. I'm still looking. Still looking around. Oh, school bus? Magic school bus? Can I, like, honk the horn? I hope it has the stereotypical, like, Dixie horn. I always think about that episode of Ed, Edd n Eddy where they find an old shaggin' wagon and Eddie hits the horn. He toots the horn on the car, and it's like the Dixie horn, but it's like kind of derpy, so it's like, and I thought that was the funniest shit. Would it be here? Oh, we got the microphone over here. Right, got the audio equipment. There we go. Oh, there's some motherfucking fireworks. I was saying bottle rockets. Yeah, man. I don't know why we have fireworks, but sure. This is a good idea. This will not end poorly, I'm sure. Let's launch that shit. Alright, Kangamato. Get fucked. Dreadwing. That's a cool fucking name. One of my favorite porcupine tree albums is called Deadwing. So that's what comes to mind, first and foremost. This guy's got a lot of HP. 125,000 HP. Yeah, this guy's kind of spicy. I mean, I'm not worried, but... We're a fucking badass. I mean, come on. This guy's a fucking chump. But he's spicier than the usual lads and ladies. I think he killed Living Flame, didn't he? Oh, he's summoning more friends. And he's getting bigger, I think. Oh, maybe that was just a visual thing. Him looking big. So we got his ass. We got all three of their asses. Oh, he's whisking himself away. Come back here and fight me, you fool. Okay, so he just has multiple phases. We're doing pretty good. Oh, I'm not doing good damage because I'm still on raid mode. That's why I was like, I feel like I'm not doing the best damage right now. Like, I'm doing okay damage, but not as much as I usually do. And it's because I'm still in normie mode. We got lots of hit points though, so it's like, hey, we're doing all right. He's out of there. So what I need to do is, I always forget this. After it is complete, we recommit. There we go. I have recommitted. Maybe I should be committed. Maybe that's the proper sentence. I need, yeah, so we're four short. That's fine. Okay, ooh, look at that, a 3-pip neck talisman, which we already have, but that's kind of cool. Plus, we have a much more exciting neck talisman that we're already working on. Of course, this will bring it to level 18. Level 18, oh shit, it's legal. Even joking about that feels kind of weird, it's like, ugh. Get that one to level 13, oh, okay, it's still 13, actually. Yeah, that one will take a while to get to, but that's fine. That's one cyclist we wanted to do. There was a few other. So there's one up that way. Up there. A dead graffiti artist. Yeah, that's we I guess that's a sign that there's sometimes ways to find out who has been like laying all this graffiti out. Who's been doing all these tags. We apparently found a bad guy, but we'll just go fast. Just buzzing along. Is it around the back? Maybe it's inside then. Must be inside. Damn it. Alright, fine, I'll go ahead and fight this guy since he's chilling right next to the window that I need to jump over anyway. Like, I can't not have to get this guy's attention, it seems. A monstrous siege. Interesting. Demonic hyenas stalking the warehouse at night. Check the door for external damage. I didn't realize this would be part of a side quest. Some attacking monsters. Let them try. Oh, did he just knock over his own dude? Hell yeah. Got the old self bonk. Did I just one shot that guy? Hell yeah. That's satisfying. Usually it shows you on the map where they're like spawning in from, but they're just kind of happening suddenly. I don't know what your dude back there is doing. He's just like, I'm just gonna be over here, vibing. I'm guessing from this side now, now that we've done left and center. Oh, never mind, I lied. he's like charging his laser, but way back there, and he just can't reach me from there, I don't think. I can't reach him either, apparently. I see there's dudes over there, and of course there's the guys flying around, but those are outside the zone. There we go. Oh, what's the difference between the Kishi and the Gagarib? I'm guessing like the Gagarib is like a higher level. And of course things are filling up unsurprisingly. However, that'll max that out, which means I can do this. Put that back there. And you fuse that shit together, hell yeah. Which is pretty dope, because once that gets maxed out, we'll be able to merge that to this feller. In fact, I'm tempted. I'm probably not going to do it, but I'm tempted to do this. Get this, like, hella leveled. But I probably shouldn't, because we would lose a lot of progress overall. But that would be pretty nifty. So slap that there. That goes to you. And then, was there anything else? You know. Yes, yes, there is. It's level 2 now. Sort this out so it's a little bit easier to follow. I'm looking more at this. I almost wonder if I should just go ahead and combine it. I was thinking about it logically. Once this gets to purple, I probably shouldn't. We would lose a lot of progress overall, but it would be a quicker turnaround. It'd be like a quicker turnaround immediately at the sacrifice of less efficiency later on. And of course, once I complete the main quest for this game, I'll be done with the game for a good while at least. I mean, this is a game I could always come back to for sure. Wait, that was the quest. Okay, never mind. I thought, yeah, there's this one here. That's for the main quest. I knew there was a side quest here. It didn't occur to me that it wasn't the one outside the door. Alright, so never mind. That one's good then. So over here is the, right, I thought the one I was looking at was the graffiti artist. Never mind. But yeah, I'll be done with this game for quite a while, I'd imagine, after we beat the main story. Because like I said, there's a lot of stuff I want to stream. But it's a game I can always come back to, especially when it comes to doing multiplayer stuff with friends, that kind of thing. Or if they were to add more single player content, more of the story stuff. Because I definitely am invested. I definitely am enjoying the story stuff that I'm seeing so far, and I'm hoping that there's a chance we could get more in the future. Even though I know this game doesn't get a whole lot of development time from Funcom. Of course, it doesn't, like, make them a ton of money. Oh, the triple one-shot? Oh, hell yeah, that was dope. This game doesn't make them a ton of money, so I know it's not, like, a huge focus for them. But it'd be nice if, you know, maybe there was hope in the future. We shall see. Alright, so what happened with this nice person who got multiple limbs torn off? Take the spray cans and make some new art. Ah, very good. Tell me I'm gonna like spray Super Hobbit was here or something. Let's make some graffiti. Yeah, let's get weird. So we can make graffiti and then... What's that say? TSW, nice. The Secret World, very nice. So we can make new graffiti. And then there's another side quest where we clean up graffiti, which is kind of cool. Now really, I feel like I can make it anywhere I wanted, but it's like more specific in saying, oh, you gotta find that shit. Like, you have to find specific areas for that shit, not just anywhere. Like, checking the backsides of houses is one thing. Like, there's already some graffiti there. There's one right here. Can't you see I'm busy? Trying to tag some places. Can't tell what that says. Aussie's something zone? I don't know, I got nothing. Is Flying Lad gonna see me? Probably not. He's high enough. High up enough. Some more over here. You can usually see these things relatively far off enough. Usually it's pretty clear. Whoop. Can't quite make that. Oh, I'd like to get that lore if I could find a nifty way up there. Ooh, here we go. I just do this. I can. And then this. Oh, overshot it. There we go. It's number one. My nose twitching all of a sudden. So that cocaine I snorted earlier. No, I'm kidding. I shouldn't joke about those kinds of things. You never know who's listening in and who might take something out of context and not know I'm joking. All right, cool. The Jindu stories. Yeah, look up in the sky. It says the crypto truths. Very cool. I feel like being up here would be a really nifty place to tag things, because you would think being higher up, like higher up areas, would be a niftier space to tag areas with graffiti, because then it's more visible and harder to reach, thus harder to clean. Go over to this side then. I feel like there's unexplored territory. There's some unrealized real estate. It's free real estate. I think I have a command for that, don't I?
It's free real estate.
It is. It is. Thank you. Thank you for reminding me. The house is free. It's a free house. Yeah, I've got a few of those. I've got a few sound effect commands. Not a ton. I don't go crazy with them, but I go a little crazy with them. For anybody curious. Not that. Sounds? Sounds. There it is. Got a nice little sheet right there that's got all the goods. Wrong button. I mean, I guess banging my hammer on the ground is not necessarily a wrong button input. We're making more friends. Oh boy. There's probably a few new sound effects I could add in. There's a couple things that have tickled my brain at one point as far as like, ooh, I need to see if I can find an isolated version of this thing. Sometimes it can be tricky though. Like, there's a few quotes from like Eddie I'd like to add in, that kind of thing, but sometimes there's a lot of background noise, so it doesn't make as much sense out of context. Or it's just harder to hear out of context. It's not quite as funsies. This is kind of a long quest, isn't it? It's like trying to find the graffiti spots. Again, I feel like there's ample spaces around me right now. Oh, here we go. Here's one. It's got to be preordained. Actually, speaking of ordained, tell me I can like tag the outside of the holy places. Aw, shucks. That's like level 99 shit, man. Going into a cult's like the spot where the cult people are like proselytizing their bullshit. That'd be a good spot to tag with graffiti, but grief? Greece? I can't tell. I can't tell what it is. I don't know how to read. Just need one more. Just one more. Of course, it's tricky. I'm losing track of where I have and have not been. We apparently just made a new friend. And I just made several friends, actually. If you really want to play, I mean, we'll play. Very briefly. Oh, there's more. Where that came from. Ouch. Okay, cool. There's that guy. Yeah, the goggle ribs are definitely stronger than the Kishis. But they're all a bunch of frickin' chumps, though. Here's the last one. I've continued the work that the graffiti artist failed to complete. So I feel achieved in that sense. I mean, of course, my inventory is getting gross because I can't waste a bunch of these things, which is annoying. Get that guy. Here's more neck talisman shenanigans. And that goes to this guy, which will level it out entirely. Very good. Awesome. So, I can max that out. And are there any other side quests? There are not. So we're done with side quests then. That's part of the main quest, even though it doesn't look like it is. I'm actually going to take the Agartha portal myself. go back to the auction house, sell off a couple things, and then hop back and commence the main story. Awful Devil's got a YouTube video. Oh, excellent. Thank you for the convenient timestamp. Yeah, that's much easier on my end, because having to manually select it. I'm definitely down for more. What's it called? Backstroke of the West. I can't help but wonder, like, how much of this was Google Translate translated, or how much of it was maybe manually conjiggered to be, like, extra silly. I'm just wondering if there was... Because there are ways when it comes to, like, Google Translate, that kind of thing, there are ways to make it extra silly looking. Like, 9 times out of 10, if you see something that says, like, oh, here's this thing that's Google Translate edition and it's extra meme filled, it was probably, like, doctored up in some ways to make it extra silly. Whee! That thing, like, really launches us, doesn't it? So let me go this way. And what I can do... Oh, not banking liaison. It'd be the auction peoples. Hello, auction peoples. I'm here to claim my cool new hammer thing. Claim it. Thank you. So now I can do a bunch of shit to this lad. And it's low level. It's blue, so all you have to do is level it up. Actually, I should hang on to this guy. That's useful. Double, actually, to really free up some space, what I ought to do is... yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then... Oh, right. That's okay, to only do so many slots at a time. Yeah. Max that out entirely. Use it with this fella. Bam, easy peasy. So we've cleared out some spaces there, and then, more importantly... Oh, not fuse. This. Hey, level 3, so now we just gotta get that leveled up. We got a bunch of things to be subjects for our targets to level up. Now we got like 10 spaces to work with, which is so much nicer. I feel like I've got so much space now. So much space. Is that something? That's a different person then. Going back down. Is that there? Can I just jump? Oh, I can't jump it. I'll be able to make it. Make the little jumpy friends. There was a machine train. Okay, that makes more sense. Yeah. And of course, yeah, the voices are just there for extra memes. But yeah, that's awesome. Let me bring that up real quick. Oh, wrong. I clicked the wrong thing. I clicked my own link. Alright, so now is the time. Wait, hold on. Just to be clear. There's nothing else that I have in progress, is there? Yeah, now is the time for main quest shenanigans. After enough side quest shenanigans as well. And I guess this is a solo instance or something, because it's putting us to like a whole new type of deal. We're just chilling in our chair though, right? We're just chilling, waiting for Kirsten to pop up. There she is, in the flesh. Outside of her office too. She doesn't look too happy to see us.
You're on mute. The talking heads are concerned. You see, shit actually flows up. You're looking bad, and that's making me look bad. And that shit stops now. Say nothing if you understand. Good. You want to get into Markod's mansion. I can facilitate that. But no more amateur hour. You're elite, and you're going to start acting like it. This is the mission file I would have given you if you hadn't gone AWOL. Think next time. Okay, sweet pea. The mansion's protected, but you already found that out the hard way. There is, however, a secret entrance. Shocker.
Secret. Right?
Don't fail. Your kind is hard to kill, true. But you can be put into an induced coma, intravenously fed liquefied kittens, and forced to listen to Nickelback for all eternity.
Okay, liquefied kittens. Almost sounds awesome. Almost.
Quick access inventory updated.
The hopeless situation parliament, yeah. We can only hope for such a line in the actual Kenobi series. Yeah, that is good. Yeah, I'm glad that they kept the Kirsten voice, for sure. It seemed like the voice actor for Che is different. Or it's either different or like he has less, he has like different direction, because he seems less animated. Like the original Che in like the original game, or in the first four chapters, I guess, was like so animated with his voice. This one, he's just kind of subdued, so I don't love it quite as much. Oh, also, yeah, so we got the weird night sky again. And shit is getting weird, apparently. The lights are on, yeah, shit's getting weird with the night sky. Check out a cool new USB drive, by the way. We just plug it into our phone. Yeah, we plug it into our little smartphone with a nice little USB to, I guess, micro USB. Either micro or mini, but I think it'd be micro for phones. Let's see. Erratic movements continue at night. Yeah. No contact from undercover agents. What's going on? So, there are underground tunnels leading to the mansion. The tunnel fails to show in scans prior to February 19th, rather. So, this was a recent tunnel, if we're going by the in-game timer, the in-game events. What caused the obfuscation of the tunnel and what changed to reveal it? So, maybe it's not so much that it was dug recently, but it was previously unbeknownst to us. Oh, interesting. That's where the word West is coming in. I gotcha. Your body is only your vehicle. There's more mindfuck. I do like the mindfucks. Yeah, because whenever we see that style of night, we saw this when we tried to open Markard's gate, and when we opened it, we just saw this like night sky thing, which is something we've seen before. Whenever we, and historically, at least. Also, there's helicopters now. Whenever we see this kind of night sky with the meteors floating and the orbs in the distance, in my experience, it usually means we're close to the filth source, or we're like experiencing the filth source, like where it's coming from. I think that's what it is. I'm not 100% clear, but it seems like that's usually what's going on there. And then the Gaia version, as of course, is Agarthas. This is like the filth, or like the dark version of Gaia, or at least the Agarthas stuff. So we gotta get over to the Anointed Precinct. Some rampaging creatures. Well, nothing we haven't seen before. Yeah, which is really cool. Yeah, the fact that you see your faction's representative handler, which makes sense. It's cool that they participate as expected. That is a nice little touch. Let's see, we have like a defense thing we're doing. Yeah, it would make sense that your faction handler would be, that appears to be based on your faction. It'd be kind of weird to be doing stuff for Templar and all of a sudden Kirsten walks in. Because presumably there's a similar sequence where you're incommunicado and your faction handler is either pissed off or concerned, or both. Oh, now we can see where they're coming from. Yeet! It's the Gagarib. Oh, but if it's... Oh, I see. So it's not so much based on the player necessarily. It's unique to whoever's viewing it. Not even if you're outside the cutscene. Interesting. Okay, so yeah. So if you were watching someone else go through that sequence... Yeah, I see. Because this person, they persist. Oh, I misunderstood. I thought you meant the cutscene. Yeah, you're saying that, like, it actually persists the faction leader accordingly. Which is nifty. Yeah, that is really cool. Yeah, outside of the cutscene. Yeah, because I was assuming the cutscene, then eventually it would warp in the faction leader, but the fact that it's all synced up properly is pretty cool. So I'm guessing all the other anointed and foundling people are being told to stay inside. Well, definitely if the foundling people are being told to stay inside, I'm wondering if the anointed people are roaming around right now. I guess we'll find out shortly. I mean, we messed up their science experiment pretty well. We murdered three of the four brother lads. Oh, speaking of brother lads, here's some more. Oh, wow, the brother lads are coming down, or the blooded lads, at least, are coming down to the anointed sections. So they're bringing out the big guns. Well, then I'll bring out the big funds. Actually, it occurs to me I probably don't have to kill them. I can probably just go around them. So go around them, I shall. There's a lad standing guard. I wonder if it's who I think it is. It's a big boy. Is it the big boy?
You go too far, little lad.
It is.
I went easy on you.
So here's Stone, I believe.
See me, meaty morsel? I am Iga Muxa. The flesh of your bones is my food. Your screams are my music. You killed my brothers. That makes me angry. That makes me happy. I don't know. But now you die.
Angry and happy. Oh. So see, I can at least stun him. So yeah, Samson, Brother Stone. And he's the guy who kicked the shit out of us in the gym previously. He's a strong boy.
Fat off the thigh, best.
He's like, ooh, I like him thick. I like my hobbits thick, he say. He's a big boy. I mean, all the giant guys, all the Agamuxa lads we fought previously have all been equally big. But he is indeed, he's a big lad. He's got a lot of hit points, too.
I'll suck the meat off your fingers!
That's strangely sexual. I need an adult. Yeah, we know these giants like to eat human flesh a lot. Like, they require the human
I'll
flesh.
Suck the meat off your fingers!
Okay, alright, thank you. Thank you for creeping me out. You're doing a great job. And of course, Living Flame's doing a great job of holding it down, man. We're doing decent damage to him. He would probably do decent damage to us, but I think we'd be able to outdamage him. See, he has a lot of health. 154,000. Ouch. Oh, I have to stay within this one. It's the donut.
Beware, little man. My death will not bring you what you desire.
I don't know. It'll be pretty cool. And being that this is the last of the lads, last of the brothers, to provide blood samples and such. Yeet. Seems like that'll be a pretty good thing to do.
No. Curse upon you, boy. My death will only bring you calamity.
Was that the last Igamuxa lore? It is not. Not even halfway through. Or no, we're exactly halfway through. Yeah, I mean that was something that all the brothers seem to struggle with. Once Living Flame is in the situation, it looks like it's a lot easier. It's still a tough fight, but not super hard. So let's see. So were they children of earth and sky? That was in the long ago, it says. Not even the brothers remember, but they do remember meeting a strange man named Markard, a man who did not fear them as they approached, hungry and laughing. A man who bound their power by, we don't know, by something. Something is protecting Markard. We can't even look long at him. He's got some fancy magics or fancy something going on. I'm surprised the scanners are still allowing us to get through. So here we are, fighting more bad guys. Yes. Bloody patrols. There we go. There's gonna be more where that came from. Yep, here they come. Oh, maybe. I saw the helicopters flying overhead. Like how the meteors that are revolving around the area that we're looking at right now, they're like kind of looming closer, it seems. Like they're looming closer to where we're at. Like they're not, they don't feel as far away. Yeah, they kind of like dip down. So like looking at those meteors, they feel like they're a lot nearer than the other ones. The ones that we've seen. Are they bad guys? I mean, there's helicopters. Oh, here we go. Maybe the helicopters are launching shit at us. Grab both of those. Yeah, I think that's coming from the helicopters. to get up to the mortars. Oh, it's someone's launching mortars at us. I gotcha. Can I run at least? I can. Oh, hoo. There was also that one dude that kept sniping us earlier, like much earlier in the game. Heavy weapon specialist. He's got a lad that's guarding him. He's fucking dead. Living Flame is nearly dead, but we'll be able to resurrect him. That one's out. This one shall soon follow. Thought I saw a sniper. There's a lot of lads. Ooh, that's a lot of boys. Are we gonna explode their booty holes?
Temporary abilities acquired.
Do I get to use the mortars? What's going on? I can't move. Maybe it's like... Yeah, I'm locked in. Maybe I need the... I'm like waiting for them to come by so we can explode their asses. Here we go. I got 9 lads. Oh shit, son. Oh, you can just click. I see, you can just click whenever you want, okay. I was thinking it was like a scripted sequence. Yeah, you can just click whenever you want and it'll just keep exploding. Is that all of them? No. Yeah, I was expecting like a reticle to show up like here, but yeah, you have to click and hold to make the reticle show. Okay, so I was very much overcomplicating that. I don't want to have these mortars forever. These things are awesome. More friends over there. Oh, a rocket launcher, lad. Busting out some heavy ordnance, aren't they? Whoa! Whoa! We got yeeted. I was gonna say, yeah, I was like, oh, do we get those heavy ordinances? I sure hope so. There's a bloody old commander. Let's go fuck him up. Oh, he's all red and glowy.
You won't get past me.
Without taking any damage from Cluster Truck. I love that game. Oh, you think you're so cool, huh? Oh!
Calling in heavy ordnance!
That's not necessary, it's fine. Lots of AoE things to be aware of. Oh, he got knocked down, nice. Maybe the explosions can mess him up. Oh wow, I'm not doing much damage to him, and he's damaging me not a small amount.
Calling in heavy ordnance!
Something keeps knocking him down, and I don't think it's me or Living Flame. There we go, we're starting to turn the tide slowly. Keep knocking his ass down, that's satisfying. I think it's the other explosion things can knock him down. Alright, he's still barriered. Of course, I have a secret weapon. Got the Z button, which will fuck him up. It won't instantly mess him up, but it'll fuck him up pretty good, though.
Yeah, this has gone on long enough.
Knocking him down. I don't think they're doing damage per se, but they are messing him up, which is kind of cool. Yeah, they're at least stunning him, which is helpful. I think the heavy ordnance is messing him up more than it's helping. It's messing him up more than anything. Oh crap, that did a lot of damage though. Shit. I think it was just unlucky timing because that was. I don't know if I could escape that, honestly. Okay, I can still win. So, no achievement, but we still got the dubski. That was a pretty tough fight, actually. There's a boss we have to damage that with AoE? Okay, cool. Now, earlier we couldn't use our scanner to get into the... We can't go this way. Gotta find some explosives. Because, yeah, last time we used a rope. So, yes, there's a boss we have to use with AoE later on, I'm guessing. A mortar round, that ought to do it. Let me goad them into launching that shit. Oh, get the fuck out. Very good. The favored Rocketeers. Oh, they're just regular humans. I was thinking like zombies or something. Oh, they have sniper rifles too? Imagine using a sniper rifle in point blank range like this. Oh, I see. You could alternatively just take zero damage. Interesting. Okay. That's interesting. Yeah, I guess I didn't notice that. I was just on kind of autopilot mode. That's good to know, though. Yeah, these guys cannot be launched, unfortunately. Got his ass. And I get the rocket launch now. Hell yeah, baby. Let's get weird. Oh, absolutely, we're getting weird. So we get the... Do we get the rocket jump? Kinda. What's this one? E is like big splody. Hold on, I need to see what these are. Big red button. Very large amount of damage to all things near a target. There we go. Yeah, this is the rocket jump. Perfect. To pop shot and then a cluster struck. I want to use the big boom on these big, on these lots of lads. Big boom! So it wasn't like a huge boom, but it was a satisfying boom. Ow. It did a lot of damage to me. Holy shit. Or maybe I damaged myself. I think that's exactly what I did. What happened, rather. Alright, so I'm gonna maybe wait for a second. Yeah, what was that? Was it my own explosion? Oh no, it was their moves. Yeah, their moves did a lot of damage. Wow. That was surprising. To like approach them, like get them from a distance if possible. Let's see if that'll grab a few of them. There we go, that got their attention. Perfect. Yeah, this rocket launch is kind of overpowered. I am super okay with that. Yeah, this is a good like tickling them move. And of course, if I need to get the fuck out of dodge, I can just use the rocket jump ability, which is super nifty. There we go. Let's see. I'm gonna like save the big guns for those guys because I see a few red boys. Actually, that's not true. I got plenty of these things. Let's do this now. That instant kill, yes it, oh almost instant kill everything. It did kill what it was able to target though. That's a lot of damage, wow. Creature from the deep? I could help you out, Victoria, and once I wrap this up. I don't know how long this sequence goes, but also I like how it's all glowy. It's all cool and glowy, hell yeah. Yeah, we'll save the guys at the gate for last. There's a lot of lads to murder. Oh, that was actually the wrong button, but I'll take it. Yeah, this ability is overpowered, by the way. I love it. It just erases an entire legion of them. I guess that area is pretty cleaned out, I'm pretty sure. I'll get their attention. I killed them both. They're kind of far away from each other. Yeah, not quite. Okay, I think this be the last bundle. It's a little mini nuke. Bam! guys are able to just tank three shots, man. Woo! Ah, they took out my cool RPG, but that's okay. More filth T-Rexes. There's a lot of them. They're just kind of running around. They're not really... Well, they're spreading filth, which is not great. Don't love that part of it. Dude, like, could you sit still? It's like they don't even want to fight me. They just want to run around. There we go. I was going to say, if they could, like, focus on me and or Living Flame, that would make this much easier. There we go. Oh, they're getting bigger, I think. Because they divided Gestalt. Oh, I was hoping to get all three of them with that one. That's okay, that's okay. They are getting bigger as we murder his friends, though. Oh my. That was a... Oh! We get more friends. I see a new portal is opening up. Boop, boop. Ouch. It's like launching filth balls. Filth cannonballs. There we go. It's like, I need to be able to fight other things, man. Living Flame can only do so much on his own. He's doing a great job, but his powers are not infinite. Last one. Clever girl, yeah. Clever, filthy girl. I think we should be okay, though. We're at a bit of a life disadvantage, but I think we're okay. There we go. So there's a hidden mansion entrance, which is going to be over that way. I don't think there's anything else here that we need to worry about, so let's get on over to it, friends. Spare parts. Let's see, what's the thing I'm looking for? It might be in this little hidey area. Ooh, or we jump the fence, maybe? Oh, I can't jump right here. Invisible walls. But a lot of invisible ceilings that I'm running up against. It's weird that, yeah, there's an invisible wall there of all places. Oh, there's a thing. A little inconspicuous button, you say. Oh, fancy. Didn't expect that. Wrath of the Dawn, there it is. That's twice now you've remembered to use your phone. We'll consider the valuable data you've mined from the morning light a down payment on your forgiveness, she says. You're becoming the APR as hell. Interest is a bitch, and so am I. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, so... Get this one. Boink. And then that goes... I think that one's maxed out. Yeah, that one's good. There was one we just leveled up, which is... Not that one. This one? Yes. Get both of those. And then that's top right. That goes to you. Bottom left. Boop, boop, boop. Cool. Anything else I wanted to use those on? Not particularly. Okay, cool. So, now that that sequence is done, I think I should be able to leave while this is in progress, hopefully. Yeah, let's see. Let me shift tab. Actually, here, help me do this. Victoria, what's your character's name? Let me see. I actually don't know how to do this necessarily. I think I could just add you as a friend, and then I could probably do a meetup. Wait. So I've added you. Yeah, that should work. That should work. I'll go do that. Now, if I add you as a friend, it should allow me to do a meetup immediately. I think I just need the nickname. I think. Ooh. That's Sealash. Oh, you sure, Jay? Okay. As long as you're sure, I don't expect you to be on hand at all times for situations like this. I'll go and add Victoria, for sure. As long as you're sure, though, Jay. I mean, like I said, your time's important, too. I don't want you to think like you have to, necessarily. I was curious to, like... I'm just curious to see what kind of gear Sealash has. Or, to see what kind of gear Victoria has. Yeah, Illuminati. Solid choice, by the way. Solid choice. Hell yeah. In my extremely biased opinion. Actually, wait. Yeah, I'm curious. Hold up. If I go back. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Just a few Illuminati. Sonny's Illuminati as well. Okay, so there's not a ton of us. It's actually spread pretty evenly. Jimmy's the only dragon right here. But yeah, Illuminati, Templar. Yeah, so it's a pretty even spread. Exit to the underground tunnel. Can we just pop right in? You'd think it'd be locked or something. I guess the button out front was one thing, but it was inconspicuous, so it's not like it was hard to find. Oh, wait, no. Inconspicuous would mean hard to... Okay, never mind, no. Conspicuous means it's easy to see, so inconspicuous means it does blend in well. So never mind, I'm full of shit. All right, let's see if we can take this all the way to Marcard's mansion. Oh, that's sweet of you, Victoria. Yeah, I mean, I like Illuminati just because I think they're interesting, but the Templar are, I think, also fascinating. I would like to see more of their story. Yeah, exactly. I think in the original version of the game, in the Secret World, TSW, I think it was pretty close between Illuminati and Templar, but yeah, I agree. I think Templar had the higher representation. And with this game, yeah, it seems, I think... Maybe it's just confirmation bias, but I feel like I see more Illuminati, but it's hard to say for sure. Exactly, yeah, it's hard to get concrete numbers. Also, Whale, good to see you, buddy. Looking at the time, I'm guessing you just got off of work. I hope it was an okay one for you, but I know it's a late night, I'm sure. You feel like their kind of stuff breaks down? Yeah, exactly. The Templar outfits are so fucking cool. Kind of the neutral... Yeah, they are kind of a neutral evil, kind of, sort of, yeah. Or maybe chaotic neutral, but there's a little bit of evil in there. I mean, you do get some cool outfits with the Illuminati. I discovered this the other day where you get, let's see, what is it? It would be under these things. Yeah, you eventually get the reinforced armor, which looks really cool. I like how this looks a lot, but this is, I feel like the reinforced armor is the, and there's this one, there's also the basic reinforced armor, which is pretty similar, just slightly less fancy, but you know, same basic idea. The reinforced armor I think looks great, but it takes a while to unlock this. I think even the low tier Templar outfits look awesome, so like you do get good stuff eventually, but you have to work a long time to get the good stuff, whereas Templar stuff looks awesome pretty much right out the gate. 47, 47, 36 for Templar. Oh right, for the instance you're looking at right now. Templar, Illuminati, and Dragon. Yeah. Was crazy, but fine. Yeah, no, I'm sure it's exhausting when it's late like that, man. It's good to see you, though, Whale. Hope you're doing well, my friend. It's always good getting to chill with you. We're playing more of this spooky game. We're investigating the tunnels underneath the compound of a cult. I already messed up the achievement, didn't I? We're going through the underground tunnels right here, trying to find access to the leader of said cult. We're trying to get into the underbelly of his mansion. Oh my. Lots of trippy traps. They really don't like us getting into their shit, do they? I hear things slapping around. Also, I guess this was a cave-in that took place. Oh, for your friend list! Oh, okay. Yes, that's actually a pretty good spread of, yeah, Templar, Illuminati, and even a good representation of Dragon. It's kind of a bummer that Dragon are the least popular, because I think they're also fascinating. Personally, I would probably pick Dragon over Templar if it came, just based on, like, lore interest and that kind of stuff. But I guess Templar are kind of a default choice for a lot of folks, which is fine, obviously. It's all down to personal taste. The Shivering Star Frequency, the Anti-Dream Prayer. The family that plays together stays together, it says. And the Ace of Ruins. This is his mansion. Or at least we're on the approach to his mansion. I'm like worried it's gonna cave in right on top of me. So yeah, that's the little tripwires. Which I should maybe attempt to not trip them. Whoops, like that one, for instance. What did I just say, Alex? Oh. He's summoning filth guardians, then that's one thing. And it sounded like a dude. Maybe that was Philip's voice himself. We've never even seen him in person. I don't think we've even seen his face before. So I do wonder what awaits us. His guardian hounds are very chonky, very beefy. Much more so than the previous lads we've had to face. Maybe not that much more so, but definitely more. Yeah, Gearston shits on you constantly, and Dragon are very incomprehensible. That tracks relatively well with what I would expect from the dragon. Very mysterious and ominous. Speaking in lots of extended metaphors, also giant fucking black widows. This is a void widow. Just a regular spider. Yeah, not like a spider demon thing. Just it's a big old fucking heckin' spider friend. Also, I can't even attack while this is happening. That's annoying. We fought spider friends before, but usually they had like demon heads or something. Now, I didn't have to fight this thing. I could have just kept going the path, but I was like, well, it's an optional enemy. Time to murder it to death. Hard to find an offhand that synergizes well with elemental. It's a good point. Yeah, I wonder what's something that would do well with elemental as the offhand. Because elemental, for me, works great as an... where elemental is the primary. For me, elemental works great as an offhand. But yeah, I wouldn't know anything off the top of my head that would synergize well with elementalism being the main player. Oh, maybe that would, like, summon the spider friend, actually. Yeah, because I use elementalism pretty much for just utility. And there are some people that don't even use an offhand. Like, I've seen that assault rifle builds can work pretty well. What do the purple guys do again? Pretty well without even utilizing an offhand. It's just all assault rifles all the time. I mean, I guess you still have the equipment for it. But just not really utilizing the skills for it necessarily. If I never ran out of ammo for your rifle. Yeah, exactly. Like, rifles are just so fucking good. Yeah, rifles are just so fucking good in this game. And they were in the original game too, but they're extra good here for sure. The Demon Hyena, the Tokoloshe Creeps, the Impundulu and Kogamatu Sor. The Takati Sorcerer goes about his nefarious business. Foundlings huddle in their huts, ignoring the sounds outside and obeying the voice of the PA system. Some foundlings grow curious. Oh, we've read that one already. Yeah, there's the Bloodied One. Yeah, I feel like we've read all this already. Definitely read the Revenants one. Yeah, we've gotten all that. The fire shotgun rounds wouldn't... Yeah, exactly. Because it's like a different type of deal. Exactly, yeah. Right, yeah. Nothing built in, which is kind of a bummer. Yeah, that is unfortunate. So it is kind of... Everything is kind of on its own island. I guess I have to just kind of follow this... pattern, don't I? Because I think the idea here is that even if I were to stay perfectly still, it would still explode and murder my face. Yeah, that's a fair point. I mean, there's a downside and a positive side too. The downside is that, yeah, it's like no nifty and convenient synergies to like make convenient build combinations happen. But yeah, it means that there's more freedom, so take the good and the bad for sure. More spider friends. Oh, hello. This time I can use abilities while I'm rooted to the ground. So I move away from the little purple friends. I remember, yeah, it's like I walked through the little smaller spider friends, and I was like, there's probably a big one pretty close by, and I like turned this way, and I'm like, oh, there he is, or she is maybe. Some corpses that she's dug up, so I guess other people have tried to get through these tunnels, and I guess it doesn't always work out for everybody. More dead bodies, very nice. Dead naked bodies, I mean, that's the best kind, right? I mean, oh, I got fucking speared. I was not paying attention. Too cheap to pay attention. Ouch. Ouch. Maybe I should cleanse that. There we go. Got fucking murdered by that spear, dude. It was pretty gnarly. Rotate hammer, chaos cooldowns. Oh gosh, that sounds like a lot to manage. Whoops. I'm doing a good job. I'm good at video games. Can I just dodge through? Oh god, am I gonna die? Yeah, let me cleanse it. There we go. Actually, I don't know if it can be cleansed. I think I just gotta get good. And to be more observant. So that's the deadest of ends, because that's where the spider friend was. And then here's where I got stabbed in every face on my body by a big old heckin' spear. It's pretty sweet. No healing was capable of. Okay, yeah, so you can now heal it right. So there were just not a lot of viable builds, right? Yeah. Oh, yikes. Yeah, that does sound unpleasant. So I know about this one now. Turns out being observant has some benefits. So if not for being able to resurrect, that would be my corpse still skewered in that tunnel right there. Wonder if anybody's ever attempted like a hardcore playthrough of this game. I mean, well, there are certain quests where you have to be dead to like go through the Shadow Realm and all that jazz. But that notwithstanding, I wonder if there's people who have attempted permadeath types of playthroughs like outside of scripted death sequences. I wonder how far people would be able to get, because there's some really tough sequences that are hard to not die from. Guardian Spoodler is almost dead, and kabow, there we go. Jimmy did it? That's awesome. He got to the end. Dude, Jimmy's a fucking boss, man. How does he do it? That's insane. Hold off a no-death run. New version of Android. Are there things that are good about it, or is it all just weird? As I understand the feels weird, man, that sometimes happens when it comes to like OS updates, that kind of thing. Oh, excuse me. Sometimes I have to stretch and make loud noises.
Is someone out there?
Can I free the buddies? It's locked. Gotta find a way out, and also a way to free the homies.
You're a fellow blue, huh? Thanks, but I'm fine. I got this.
So I guess these are Illuminati agents. We heard that there were Illuminati agents that were missing. Oh, there's some down here too. He's like praising the sun. Did it in 4 tries. Leave That's incredible. Here. Looks like an iPhone in some ways. Really? Can I ask what kind of phone you got, Will? Like what model? Because mine's the Galaxy S8, which is kind of old at this point. It's like 4 years old. 3 or 4 years old, but yeah, mine hasn't gotten any significant updates. I mean, it gets updates, but nothing huge. So more about Markard's mansion. So there's the family friend, Baryun. Uncle Barry, what kind of zany hijinks is he up to this week? He plays with a toy, it says. Pieces of third-age technology co-opted and mashed together. No mortal of this age should know how to do this, but the Markards have unusual patrons, it says. So Baryon practices his control of the metal juggernaut. He's got murderous mischief in his eyes. Oh, Uncle Barry.
Classic what the hell are you doing?
Uncle Barry. But no one but Uncle Barry. So, I mean, there's blood, there's like, you know, signs of unpleasant things. There's like some dead rats and pigeons hanging. That's something. I guess maybe that's what they're being fed. But no obvious corpses or anything, so that's encouraging.
Kill me!
So they're not having a good time. A mostly naked mannequin with a mask of some kind on its head. That's kind of fucked. And of course, a pewter. Not sure what's going on with these mannequins. I see some car batteries. Oh boy, that's not a good sign. Some demon friends.
The family. They're... Oh god.
Is there someone in there?
They're not right. They're not right.
I wonder whose voice I'm hearing right now. There's... Oh. Oh my, so there's... kid stuff happening over here. Are you telling me that there's like... children playing down here from time to time? Or unless it's like children, like ghost children, like from like the nurseries, the nursery section, that kind of thing, like that kind of deal. Got the S10 Plus. Okay, so yours is a decent bit newer than mine. Is there a Selkie inside of here?
Leave me here.
Apparently there is. Someone said leave me here. What's this? Like a trash compactor, I guess. There's a very sad voice that does not want me to release them. Doesn't fit the lock.
Just go.
What is this? Oh, it's one of the T-Rex monsters, okay. Can I open this one? I can't open this one. That one's a key card, I see. In fact, I can't click any of these. Is there another key I was supposed to have grabbed?
Just go.
The demon dog lads. Hyenas. Doesn't fit that one. The agent we were sent for. Oh, it sounded like there were a few agents that we were looking for. Oh, here we go.
Kill me!
Murder. Murdered to death. Oh, it's unleashed now. Maybe that's a fight you're expected to lose. He's on the hunt now. All right. Well, he's gonna do his thing. Also, some nifty lore.
Kill me!
So I guess they're doing some experiments then. What is that? Oh, it's the right. Yeah, it's the beaked lads. Yeah, instantly just deleted my ass. So down in the depths, down in the dungeon, just Hoople and me.
Leave me here.
This inhuman cave. He can have refuge from his family, but he loves his family, but sometimes he needs to escape them, he says. He keeps his hobbies, experiments on his captives. He has supernatural fauna of all types. He has agents from all major secret factions, and he takes great pride in this. Gotta catch them all. Collect the whole set. Another wholesome coming together.
The family. They're... Oh, God.
So one thing I'm not 100% clear on,
they're not right.
These voices, these people are like, no, right. we're fine. But who's talking? It's not this guy. Are the voices coming from the monsters? Are those the kind of, is that the kind of shit that they're doing right now? Also, where did that monster friend go? I'm kind of curious to see where he went. Like maybe I was supposed to follow him. It is the people. Okay, cool. Oh, it just despawns. Okay, cool. Thank you, Jay. Because, yeah, when I first walked up, they were like, nope, we're fine. It's cool. Don't worry about it. And now they're like, oh, God, we're fucking miserable. Just please kill us. Yeah, the insta-kill is for the lore. It's worth it. It's the price of knowledge. Okay, so let's try the computers. Man, there's some things here I'm not so happy about, dude. There's car batteries, there's coat hangers, there's flashlights and whips and spanking devices. I see some sickles and hammers and... Oh, yeah, there's some shit going down here, man. My card's into some shit. So, here we go. Observation and research. Yes, the Dreamers Awaken, it says. So you get to learn more about lots of monster friends. Wendy's and a Tasty Burg and some nugs? Dude! As always, man, Whale knows how to celebrate a post-work...
Leave me here!
...instance. That sounds fucking dope, dude. Whale's out here we're out here and living in 2021. Whale's in 3021 being like, yo, the Wendy's experience is where the real good shit is. So let's see, the sleepers dream of the ocean. The dreams make manifest in the Draug's flesh. Their life cycle is fascinating, he says. A delight to behold. But they are impractical. Mutation of the flesh without ascension of the wind. Encrusted, club-like limbs ill-suited to our ultimate pursuits, he says. They are wondrous curiosities. The pickled punks of a carnival floating in the brine. I look, I delight, but I move on, he says. So I guess he's looking at the...
Just go.
The versatility, or like the, what's the word I'm looking for? The viability of certain filth-infused monsters and how they can be used to continue his will. So vampires, what are their origins? Do they come from Transylvania? Research suggests otherwise, it says. Their hunger is inspiring. The experimentation is...
Just go.
The experimentation to create super soldiers via vampiric blood is also inspiring. We'll begin our own initiative using the blood of the Agamuxa, which we've, of course, seen a lot about. Another being of hunger. There are eaters and they're the eaten and the eaters. Let us be the latter, it says. What about the Akab? Strange and vile things. What could we possibly learn by studying them, he asks. Werewolves. So for lycanthropy, to have plural forms, are they truly shapeshifters? Is there infinite potential, or are they shackled to set configurations? To change one's form is a step into letting go of the self. We must know more about what is happening under the fearsome hide, he says. Zombies? It's vulgar to use this name from popular culture. Reanimated corpses are ravenous purely for the sake of ravenousness. They ingest but do not digest. Given enough food, they will eat until their distended bellies explode and then eat more. The chewed mush sliding out their ruptured gut. We have observed this. Well, that's just delightful. I'm guessing he likes the demon hyena. The communal memory of this place, and from that myth, I stitched together the flesh to contain the hungry spirits at my command. The Kishi and the Gagarib. They wear the rich context, and it gives them power. The people recognize the names, these shapes, and what are names but a means of shaping reality. This gives the demon hyena the glamour and majesty of horror, he says, so he likes them a lot. The Kangamato, the flying lads, beaked lads even. They were human once, a lost people. They found primordial flesh impossibly preserved in the bowels of a cave. They ate of the flesh, and it changed them. And so they were until I found them and brought the word of the sleepers, which nourished in ways that flesh cannot, he says.
What the hell are you doing?
Sorry, I'm reading, lady. Got it nice and fresh. Ooh, buddy. Hell yeah, that sounds good. Hot off the grill. So, recent additions from our forward operation, the Congo specimens, that is. Living fossils, it says. This is but a sample of the wonders that await.
Leave me here.
Like a certain tittering voice, we now stand outside of time. We have access to all of time, it says. We are the light from the deviant direction that shines on the well of time, the wall of time, and its sister dimensions. Okay, anyway, yeah. What else? So, interesting research about what he thinks about various creatures and fauna.
Shh.
Also, it was worth noting that he was saying the Congo specimen were like living fossils, and we just fought a saber-toothed tiger thing that killed me instantly, as well as the demon T-Rex things we fought previously. Whoa, whoa. Dude, I'm getting learned over here, dude. Interrupt me. It's rude. Anyway, as I was saying, so rudely interrupted. So, containment cell 1, empty. Number 2, agent of Illuminati. 3, are 2 dragon. 4 is Templar. And an agent of an unknown faction to be questioned. Interesting. So, and so 1, 3 Phoenicians. And 2 is test subject disposal. Some kind of cleaning service is needed. Yeah, it's like, I wonder what faction this guy's in. Ah, he opened the door for us. Hey, hey, that's perfect. Here's a way out of the basement. Just what I was looking for. Looks like we're in the mansion proper now. Oh my. See a laser grid? Yeah, it's definitely on lockdown. Who knew it would be that simple? But we're not done yet. There's still plenty left to do. There's Philip, the handsome patriarch. Eliza, the beautiful matriarch. Catherine and Alexander, daughter and son. Oh, Alexander. Alexander. Sorry, whenever I get like the R-E instead of E-R, it always kind of throws me a little bit. And then there's Tiberius, the family dog. Oh, I think I know where that's going to go. Watch the nuclear family come together, cell to cell. Watch them bond through active transport. See them coalesce. Gestalt. Philip Marquardt asked for the perfect family and the outer dark provided. He tends them with all the obsession of a man fetishizing the green god called Lawn. They talk about like how this nuclear family is like all together. I wonder if they're... I mean, it sounds like the other family members are just constructs, but I wonder if they're gonna like form together like a Voltron or something like that to fight us or something. There's the perfect family. So pristine. Can I bang on the piano? Yeah, I just want to stomp on it so I can play the keys. I want to bonk the keys, please. Confront Philip. Oh, cutscene time. Do we get to see the man, the myth, the legend himself? In the flesh? Some good voice acting? Ooh, I'm excited. We heard his voice earlier. At least I think it was his voice.
We have guests.
Oh my.
He should not be here. My husband receives guests. We will receive Catherine, Alexandre.
Alexandre.
Come. Oh my. We have guests to receive. Lovely guests. They smell like stars. Stars. You will be received.
That is some good voice acting. You were not wrong, Jay. You will be received, they say. Oh boy. They say something tells me these are gonna be not easy fights. Oh, doggy. Oh, I don't wanna fight doggy. I can't fight doggy, okay. I can fight wife lady. Matriarch. So I gotta avoid doggy. I can't even fight children, and so it's only lady. Eliza. Jesus, the demon children are kind of terrifying, aren't they? Leave me alone, filth doggo. I have no quarrel with you, good sir. Or ma'am. Well, Tiberius is probably a dude. Looks like that's a donut. I could probably just stay within the donut and be fine. I think the dog is mostly AoE, so I can just dodge it. Dip, dive, duck, dodge, and... Well, dodge, dip, dive, duck, and
children,
dodge.
Join me! The family is close. The family is one. The family is close.
The family is one.
Jesus. It is the fucking demon
gift for my husband.
Well, that's fucking terrifying.
The host comes soon.
who's the guest?
Cool as fuck, though. I love it. I wonder if they were normal people at one point. It sounded like he, like, Philip had requested this family as a, as, like, I guess something from the filth specifically. And that the darkness provided it, so it's like, were these normal people at one point, or was it like he had a family and they were filthified and beyond fucked up? Just kind of just waxing out loud.
Cannot die. We stay outside, Diamond.
Sounds like a challenge to me.
And this family is only a fleshy proteries of me that sleep. So you.
Fleshy protuberance.
You.
Whoa. I probably didn't need you to pop the heal, but I went ahead and went for it. Almost got her. Got them. The nuclear family, yeah. The fleshy protuberance. Whatever that cool word was. Alright. That was fucking dope. Yeah, that's fucking creepy. I love it. I want more of that shit, dude. Give me more.
Power. The sleeping mouths whisper the riddle. And the riddle is, power can make you weak. You were given power.
This guy.
Such power. You've leaned upon it for so long. But now, I've taken your power. What are you without it? You are nothing. You are less than nothing. You barely even exist.
Remember him from the Scorched Sands, and I think City of the Sun God, but definitely the Scorched Sands. Yeah, he was I assumed he was like a filth or Orochi representative that one general dude was always conspiring with. But I guess it sounds like he was working with Morning Light all along. But I mean, anything with the filth apparently is aligned with Morning Light anyway, so I guess it kind of makes sense. Can't hit show with the huge hammer. 0 out of 10. Literally unplayable. Because of some Cooks Serve Delicious lore. I know that there's like more than meets the eye. Excuse me, more than meets the eye in Cooks Are Delicious 3. I don't know that, but I've heard that there's like more to it than one would expect. Because between Cooks Are Delicious 1 and 2, there was some lore, but 3, it gets even more wild and weird. Yeah, whatever came of that guy. Yeah, because there's a lot of loose ends. Cassandra King, Beaumont, for that matter, too, because we know he's not dead. I don't think, at least. But yeah, the dark outfitted gentleman. Mysterious stranger, and has some crossroads vibe to it. Crossroads vibes to him. Because it was never abundantly clear. We know that he was like some kind of agent of the filth or of darkness. But yeah, it sounds like he was aligned with the Morning Light all along. Yeah, I don't know. Very interesting stuff. So what can we do here? We can, of course, we're nice and punchy. What if without our powers? Well, we're nice and punchy. Can I not use my items? Oh. I can't use my items at all, yeah. Can I, like, rip open the door or something? Big loose end is back, that's correct.
Which way? Well, hold on. I found them. You're in it deep, eh, hero?
Yeah, I killed his family. He didn't like that.
Hey, don't worry. Dr. Che's got the medicine.
You just sneeze a bee at us?
All better? Forgive me, hero, for I have sinned. It's been a dog's age since my last confession. Markad isn't here.
Ah, shucks.
To be fair, I didn't say he was here. Just that I'd get you into his house. After you got me the goods, I was just gonna leave you here to rot, run off, fall back on my sin-shitty ways. But I had a change of conscience, religious experience. I got a call. He wants to talk to you.
Hiya, Chuck.
It's John.
You and I have got some fucking big... But I am a merciful abomination, and this isn't where you die.
Is he mad at us?
The Congo. You'll find Markard in the Congo. Be seeing you.
Be seeing you? Why would John be mad at us? Interesting that Shay's got a direct line in with John. Also, I like how when we talked to him on the phone.
Round two with that Barahun creep? Any dude preaching apocalypse.
Oh, that's who he is. That's Uncle Barry.
He's trying too hard, man. Kinky, kinky. Looks like they're putting the bloody screws to your fellas down there. Grade A torture. Sorry about the double cross. No hard feelings, right?
Yeah, it's like when we answer the phone, we have to like stuff the phone under our mask. Like, there's no way for this to go, so I'm just gonna like shove it underneath there.
Get a load of these creepy crawlies. Straight out of the Congo. Fan-fucking-tastic!
He's really excited about these demons. Just see where Shay's going. Also, the buff scales your stats. Oh, okay, so interesting. So we got debuffed slightly. Not too much, but, you know, a bit. What do you think? What do you make of this? Loose thread games instead of, yeah. Because Ragnar, that was like one of the main writers for this game originally, right? Or like one of the main people in Funcom. Red thread games, okay. So the Congo would be like the next section, presumably, like the next major section. Oh, I'm sorry, Victoria, yeah, that does suck. Having that getting knocked out while you're video gamings. There are Kaiden dungeons. Oh, okay. Yeah, Shaper. Yeah, exactly. Like, I guess. Yeah, I don't know. It's a little bit weird how he was. Like, he did say he'll get you in, but yeah, at one point he did say Markard on. I think the quote was on a fucking platter. They did bring one of the bosses, but it's not in the game. Right, okay. Oh, the Aegis system. Interesting. Okay. Oh, interesting. Okay, that would explain why maybe he's not so happy with this, because, yeah, the filth in Tokyo is kind of his thing, for better or for worse. I mean, pretty much mostly for worse. Of course, the dungeon wouldn't be required. Like, that's not, you know, a required thing for the players to do necessarily, but that's interesting. Yeah, was there anything else? Yeah, nothing else. Okay, cool. So in that case, let's find Barry, Uncle Barry once more. He was able to knock us out with some kind of gas. And then, of course, you know, disabled our powers.
What? You? No.
Is that you up there?
I beat
it
you.
It is.
I made you nothing. No matter.
Patchwork Juggernaut.
I've seen who you are under your
chest. Ow.
And now
I was outside
I
the range.
Destroy.
Something tells me this is going to be a spicy fight. Photon Howitzer? Oh my. Looks like I'm out damaging him right now, so it's probably fine. Also, that fire is not good. And now he's focusing on Living Flame, as he very well should. Why are you laughing? Why are you laughing? I'm winning. Oh, he killed Living Flame. No, my Living Flame buddy. Oh, he's doing something. Why can I not target you now? Is there
more happening? This has been diverted, but I have work to do.
Powering down. I mean, his health bar wasn't empty, so... Oh. I disrupt this in some way. Climb the ladder. I'm guessing he's healing him. And I, like... Let's see, that door is closed. I squeak by there. No, what can I do about this? You're standing back up. Yeah, he's healed up now. Gotta find some way to stop that from happening. More ESO, yes, I heard about that as well. Yeah, some new ESO expansions coming out pretty soon. And this little, the one that's coming up is apparently gonna be a pretty big one, as I understand it. Adding companions and such. Oh, that's targetable. Yeah, I saw the red glowy thing. I had assumed that I couldn't hit it. As I didn't see it as like a... I tried to mouse over and I didn't see anything. But yeah, if it's targetable, I'll try that then. Thanks for pointing that out, Jay. That sounds like that'll be just what I needed. There we go. So now it's our next opportunity. You're gonna do your bullshit? Or what? Now, why are you still hitting me? I can't even target you. Here, come over to your platform.
This has been diverted, but I have work to do.
Okay, there he goes. He's gonna give him the old zappy. Cause yeah, I remember seeing that his arm was colored. Yeah, this right here. Oh, it is chart. Yeah, it's just outside the thing, it seems. Yeah. Like I hit it once. Oh, there we go. That's the weak point. Did I get it? Clicking. Maybe I didn't click it good enough. It's powered up again. Just gotta get good. Also, that is a lot of fire that's still there. That was lucky timing. Yeah, the photon howitzer thing is something I definitely like to stop. Just because that move is not very nice.
Give in to oblivion.
Oh, there's a reveal trailer for it too. That's good. That's what he's about to go down for the third time. Alright. Let's try it again. I'm not sure what I was doing wrong. It seemed like there was a sweet spot he had to stand.
It is inevitable.
You gonna power down, dude?
This has been diverted.
There we go.
But I have work to do.
Give me this arm now. So it's like outside the barrier. This has been diverting. Oh no, it's still this one. That's like if I don't move my mouse at all and just keep slapping. There we go. Ooh, and I got healed. How about them apples? Now what? It's not targetable. It's on fire, though. Oh, I hope he mad. Just too much stuff going on. Yeah, it's like got new moves now. I haven't played the game myself, but I've like watched it played a lot, and the game looks awesome. But yeah, it does look like a lot to keep track of, especially like from the outside looking in, relatively speaking. Just a lot of game to that game, so... It is a lot. Especially from someone who hasn't played Oblivion or Skyrim. I've only played Morrowind. Man, we're messing this guy up, though. Of course, he's been paying a lot more attention to Living Flame.
Do you like my toy?
I know you like this toy. Oh, come on, man. You don't get to just attack me when I can't even target you, man. That's some bullshit.
Your efforts are
just a lot of stuff. Yeah, it's just very involved.
You will heal my new pet.
It's a lot of content. So it's got a lot of stuff to do and a lot of, there it is. And this is really annoying. It's so finicky. can just do this, I guess. Oh man. Gonna do this bullshit at me. That's what got me last time. Ah, that sucks. Yeah, I couldn't even target it. That's really annoying. Oh well, thankfully it's pretty easy to take down. Oh, maybe it's okay, maybe I should let Living Flame die then. Oh, that makes me sad. Or maybe I could like try to pull him off of it. That's unfortunate. Living Flame's such a useful little buddy.
You are an insect.
That move. I don't like this move. At least let me run this way. Thankfully it looks like he does replace the old flames. So Living Flame is done. So we'll not resurrect him. There we go, there we go. Much better.
Die.
Yeah, get mad. Yeah, it's going back to the center. Right, yeah.
What is this power?
Let me smack this man. Smack this hand right here. Perfect. We got the heals. Just got two flamey hands. I'm guessing I'll have to do that with his legs next, probably. Wait, do I keep going? I think that's it. Yeah, I think that's it. Oh, I ran through the flames like an idiot. Get over here!
I will crush you!
Get around these flames real quick. Just run kind of along this barrier. Seems like the laser doesn't damage you while it's being laid down, but of course the flames will be problematic.
Best you can hope for is agony.
Oh, lasers. Oh my. Good that they telegraph what they're doing, because that would be spooky otherwise. Oh wait, don't do that, don't do that. It's like second nature sometimes. Can't help it.
It is inevitable.
A lot of talk from some dude who's about to get his favorite toy messed up. I'm guessing this attack fucks you up real bad if you get hit by it. Just because it looks very fancy. Dang it, I was hoping that I'd be able to cancel it out. Oh, his shit's on fire, hell yeah. Love to see it. What next, leg time?
What is this power?
Go ahead and do your thing. I know you want to. Oh, it's up here. Well, this will be the final weak point to this lad. That's on fire too. His shit is more on fire. Yes. Oh, it explodes ass. I bet he's not dead. I bet there's more where that came from. Oh, hey, Illuminati friends. So, what's up, buddies? Is everyone rescued? Oh, shit, Kirsten's here, yeah. Eat the light. It was delicious, thank you. He's like, what if I just poke it a little bit? There's his hat. Wonder if he is dead. I don't know. Heed the words of your faction
kudos
handler.
Where kudos is due. Barahoon was in our top five most wanted.
Was. Now he's fucking maybe dead. I don't know. Maybe he's assumed dead, but I don't know, man. I'll believe it when I see it.
One Barahoon is worth a get off the shit list free card. You are in my good graces. Now it's time to go home. Word to the wise. Quit while you're ahead. Back away from the blackjack table and insert whatever gambling metaphor you want here. Next up is the Congo. Now I want you at peak aptitude. No premature invasion. You go only with my intel and my blessing. Now nod. Oh, they grow up so fast.
Okay. So I'm guessing then that that means that's the end of what's available right now. Yeah, await word from your faction handler. So now, we wait. That means we're done with the story. So the main story for this game is done up to this point, at least. This, well, he I'm sucked. Sorry, I sure hope he doesn't.
Did I give you the impression we were hanging out? Go.
I'm sorry. I'm talking to my friends. I'm sorry. All right, cool. Well, that was awesome. That was a really cool sequence. And yeah, like the stuff at the end, or right before the end where we were fighting the nuclear family. Dude, that was fucking wild. I want more of that kind of shit, dude. That was so fucking cool. Yeah, this was a really cool part of the game. I really liked this, and it did start off a little bit slow, but once it got going and things got weird, oh baby. So good. Top, on a lot of dangerous top five lists, helps reestablish some of your cred back at the office. It's to end on the ground floor of the next leg, so back to the Congo, or to the Congo next. But don't start without us this time. Yeah, I guess us going rogue was maybe not the right look. Not the right call, but I don't know. It's like we just, on the one hand, it's like we're rewarded for taking initiative and such. But on the other hand, it's like, well, sometimes it doesn't go so well. Sometimes it's not always reflected, in a good way. Put that. Excuse me. I keep hiccuping. Put that right here. Okay. So now I'm guessing we can just go out. Actually, I'm kind of curious what it looks like now. If we go out the way we came. Oh wait, we can't go out the way we came, can we? Is everybody freed? Yeah, even the dude who was the mysterious. Oh god, I just noticed the video camera too. And the bug, like the bug infestation in the blood puddles. So we rescued all the homies, even the people who are trapped down here. A hidden door. Yeah, let's go back. Yeah, the corn picking action was definitely top tier. One of the best corn picking simulations I've ever experienced in a video game before. Need some banana plantations? Yeah, coffee harvest? Okay, now I'm down. We're talking some Harvest Moon dungeon shenanigans. So if I go outside. Oh, more little buddies. Maybe I shouldn't have tanked that. See what our buddy says, the Council of Venice lad who just messaged us. Yeah, so now it's back to normal, more or less, I think. Of course, there's all these areas out here. I guess if there were side quests, they would be available to us, that kind of thing. But yeah, we've I think done South Africa pretty much as we could. Oh, maybe I should read this before I teleport out away. Until my extraction, I'll continue operating as I have. Come see me in the Anointed District. Oh, interesting. Oh, he was at the council, right. Okay, we could go to the Anointed District then. See what he's got. He's like, yo, thanks for the whole letting me not die thing, fam. Wonder what our reward's gonna be. I hope it's a firm handshake. We have to awaken. Sleep till morning, yes please. Right, so that means that the main stuff for this game is done, the main story. Like I said, unless they were to make new story stuff, then, hopefully they will make new story stuff. Hopefully they're working on it right now, or we'll be working on it soon. So, at which point, once it's available, I'll definitely come back and continue the main story with this character. But in the meantime, there's a few more side quests I want to do, including the one for Marky Mark over here. Welcome. And like I said, I'll start tonight and probably continue on Thursday some side quests that I want to do. There's an investigation quest I want to do that's available in Agartha. Actually, I think, well, the cutscene for it happens in London, so I'll probably just start it in London proper. Get the actual proper experience. There we go. But beyond that, there's also some action quests that I want to do, and also there's a sabotage quest here that I want to do. Oh, and speaking of loose ends, there's that one dude who was planting like teleportation device, or not teleportation, transmission devices everywhere. Hey. We caught a glimpse of him, but he ran away before we could catch him. I wonder if that loose end is going to be tied up at some point.
I'm still conducting the council's work as best I can until I can be
extracted. Could do more stuff to earn more of Dawn's favor. And after a while, oh, I see. Speak with the council to purchase unique items. Okay. Like cool masks and distillates and such. Okay, that's neat. Some cool outfits. Here's Marky Mark. So, oh yeah, so you have to turn in the points. And we have... How many points do I have? Not that. This. No, not that either. Crap. You can make your guy look kind of bloodied. There's a way to see my currency.
Worship and prayer sessions will occur during every lunch.
Can't remember how to do it.
Please participate.
There we go. I apparently clicked it. So I have 70 of Dawn's favor right now, so you can get a random distillate, which is nifty. That's actually really cool. Random distillate, that's nice. Some witch doctor garb. Okay. Guys of the... Oh, cool. You can make dress stuff like a Kangamato. That's neat. Oh, that's much nicer than... Yeah, I was worried it was like it would like skip the cutscene, so I was going to travel to London just to make sure. But yeah, if it just directs us to the quest giver, that's much nicer. All right, so we get some experience. And some bonus Dawn lore. So he's expecting a dead drop from a fellow agent, but a chorus guard spotted him. Gotta find a new spot, but he's not sure where. Let's go find the dead drop. Oh, boy. Oh, let's check the notes. Oh, we don't get the notes. Find the dead drop, and it could be just about anywhere. There's also other lore things to get. Yeah, there was this one over here, the mysterious gift basket, which we had seen previously. There's a bunch of random locations. Oh, buddy. Yeah, just look for a small folder. Okay, cool. Thank you for giving me what to know what to look for, at least. This mysterious gift basket. I kind of spoiled it a little bit by reading the text, but yeah, let's see what this is. We actually haven't even looked at this, really. What could it possibly be? See, fresh fruit, some wine. It looks nice. Your admirer, it says. Boom. Oh! This is not a good gift basket. So, Marika, it was intended to presumably murder Marika, then. She was already murdered, obviously.
Visual tracking initiated.
Shit got exploded. But there are muddy footprints. Ah, interesting. Yeah, maybe I'm thinking is like, if I could follow this, and then maybe while I'm doing this type of deal, we could keep an eye out for the folder. Wherever it could be. So Sniper Lad and landmines are here. Which is unique, to say the least. Ouch. So apparently there was quite a series of traps laid out for Marika and, or by extension for me, I suppose. This is all happening in broad daylight, obviously. He just snapped me out of the open and no one seems to really mind what's going down.
Hello.
Ducking behind cover. Also looking for folders. As I guess it could be interior or exterior.
Hello.
Like looking for any spots that look like something could be tucked away conveniently. So keep switching up locations.
Hello.
So, like these bushes would be a nifty place to hide such things.
Be the change you want to
see. Okay, that would count as a dodge then. Okay, good. That's good to know. Yeah, I sometimes wonder how well the dodging would work for situations like that, but that is good to know. Future reference. See, it looks like this is taking us off the quest area. God, everyone's so, like, strangely cheerful despite how fucking murderous everything is. Oh yeah, this is... I can tell already, this is one that would take quite a while. Will take quite a while. I almost wonder if I should put this one on hold and just focus on the main task at hand. Also, it is getting late, it's almost one. And as is the common theme, of course I can't stay up too terribly late. So we'll have to wrap up fairly soon. Continue finding the sniper though. Okay, so we're chasing him all the way out this way.
Walk in the light.
Also looks like maybe the drop could be out this way, so let me check the bushes. See the same thing out this way, because this is within the circle. So if it's within the circle, then it's doable. Listen, oh, there's a thing that marks it? Oh, okay. It wouldn't be in the bushes? Oh, okay, cool. Log into- oh, I mean, that's sweetie to offer, Jay. Like I said, I wouldn't expect you to drop everything to help my- to bail my ass out. I mean, of course, the help is always appreciated, but I know it's getting late, so if you got other stuff to do, that's totally fine.
Have you become anointed?
You've already done so much for me, my friend. Sniper is up top somewhere. It's one person who has it out for either me, specifically, or for Marika. Tracking device, you say? Oh, here we go. There was a gentleman that had tracking devices.
Radar module activated.
So maybe this is going to lead into that loose end we saw previously. Somewhere around here.
Welcome.
Getting warmer.
Item located. Your body is only your view.
Oh, there we go. Oh,
gotcha.
Temporary abilities acquired.
Oh, it's hot potato. Oh, I see. I mean, a hot potato. I just threw the green back at him.
Change.
Yeah, sorry, I'm just juggling grenades over here. Snapper's blood trail. Oh, he ran away. I thought he died. I got all excited. I mean, this is a lot of blood, so he's handling this pretty well, all things considered. The van. Interesting. That's, look at all this blood. Man, how's this man not fucked? Giant handprint, too. Another device. Oh, is it gonna explode? It's suspicious and it has TNT on it. Or not TNT, but plastic explosive. Ouch. This guy's mean, man. He's got a lot of ordnance, too. Across the globe. Threat killer. Come back here, you fool.
Bounty's dead or alive.
Call an ambulance, but not for me. Got his ass. Check his phone. Disturbing details continue to surface, but there are perpetrators at large. Multiple governments and agencies working in tandem on the investigation. Officials say capture is imminent. So I'm the assumed ringleader, Alex Superb Halfling Hobbertson. Given the public outcry and the ever-rising bounty on the heads of the perpetrators, the message is clear. The world wants these terrorists brought to justice dead and alive. Or dead or alive. What was the nature of the weapons? Details still sketchy. Okay, yeah, that actually was kind of cool. And of course, QBO would pin this on us because, you know, kind of goes against their business interest to tell the truth about this. Internet famous and viral. That can be a lethal combination, but we'll come out of it okay. We're going to be a pain, but we have media connections too, so you can live to fight another day, and the next one, and then maybe the next one. And it'll cost you, all it will cost is looking over your shoulder for the rest of your life. It's not so bad, right? How bad could it be? Let's go ahead and turn these in real quick. Not turn them in, but power them up. Like that, friend. And this guy. And listen. Actually, I should be powering up that one just because that has more interesting things going on. There we go. Excellent. So we just got the party invite from Olin. Oh, did I? I might not have picked the thing correctly. I saw the pop-up thingy, but maybe didn't click correctly. It's my new login reward. I'll claim it to my stack of anima slurpee that I'm not gonna use anytime soon, apparently, just because I keep hoarding these things like a dragon. Jeez, lost. Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Yeah, power's still being weird. I know you said it's storming pretty bad out there, Victoria, so it's, I'm sure it's kind of gnarly. Ooh, some New Dawn lore. The first of the New Dawn lore. How did I miss that? Can I just cheese it? There we go, yeah. And I can't cheese it from here. Sometimes you can cheese it in creative ways. Trying to be a cheesing son of a bitch. Crap. Let's try to find a way to get on this roof.
Hello.
What I'm trying to do, stand on this guy. Whoop. Hey, here we go. It feels cheesy, but we got it. There it is. The bright darkness will change the world, they say. The dreaming ones. Alright, let's get back up to the north section where we can see more about this whole, or the south sections rather. We can work more on this whole finding the thing, finding the folder. So it wouldn't be like in the exterior bushes areas, it'd be very much within the main spots. Which makes sense. I mean, I feel like it could be anywhere, but it's good to know that there are some limitations as far as what to expect. We should go to where Jay is. I know she said that there's a thingy that she has.
Welcome.
Aha, there she is. Two random locations. Yeah, I'm surprised that there's so many like different spots where it could be. Makes for a very comprehensive mystery experience where it's like, oh man, there's not like one guaranteed place. It could be anywhere. Some kind of dead drop. Any kind of place where it could be just chilling somewhere. I'm trying to keep my eyes peeled for like any kind of crevice that where it could be hidden into. I hadn't even thought about like the interior places and such. By the corn, maybe? I've mentioned before that as a Prodman Westerner, I'm always down for more corn adventures. That's just a book. Oops. Yeah, every time I see an overturned book, it's like, well, not a folder, but it has paper in it, so it's good enough for me. Nothing this way. Going into the back rooms. I don't know. That could be a sneaky place. Oh, here it is. There's the dead drop. Hell yeah. Well done, Jay. There it is. Excellent. Thank you for finding this. That's perfect. Gotta bring it back to old Marky Mark. So yeah, within 24. Yeah. So it's like a little fun add-on thing that kind of points out those kinds of key quest items. That's a very sneaky one. And like it said, 50 locations. I mean, oh man. I wouldn't have thought it would have been in that space specifically. Hey. I would have thought it would have been in another, like, interior area, but maybe one of like the residential spots or something. Oh, it took you. Yeah, I was gonna say that could take a long time. Yeah. Yeah, that your assistance, Jay, was super helpful because, yeah, without you being here, that would have been. I like to think I would have eventually found it, but it would have taken a minute to put it nicely. Here's Marky.
You have my
there he is. Your field report has been received. Excellent. We got more good boy points. How many good boy points are we at right now? Thank you again to Jay. That was very kind of you to help me out. Bailing my ass out. That was good. What did I click last time? I think I clicked this guy. No, not that one. There we go. You click the anima shards. We're up to 86 good boy points.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. So there's a subtle beeping emitting from a nearby bed. Our cabin is bugged. Let's listen. It's very, very obvious. Another tracking device type of deal.
Radar module activated.
This way.
Welcome.
Mildly this way, so it's going to be quite a ways away. It could be in the anointed section. In fact, I bet it is. Oh, I'm in the anointed section. Oh, okay, never mind. I'm full of shit.
Please move away from the wall.
I meant the favorite section, but yeah, I don't think we can get up there now if we wanted to. Oh, but it's getting closer. I hear battle music. Now this guy, an unknown agent. Yeah, this guy looks a lot like the mysterious lad we saw previously who ran away when we found him with the tracking devices and all that jazz. And he dropped like 1,000 of them too. Ouch. These guys seem not hard to fight, just annoying to fight. Are you trying to warp out? He is. The new Carthage. New Carthage was a name I've heard previously, so maybe that's the unknown faction that we're speaking of. Yeah, it's like, I wonder if there's more lore that's kind of baked in from the writers that hasn't been realized yet necessarily, has not been revealed yet necessarily, but more lore about other faction things that are going down. So mysterious. Alright, very good. Alright, so how's about this? I think that's it for side quests around here. Looks like there's one more that's a mechanic. I could maybe grab that one real quick. It'll probably be fairly quick. Let's go and grab this last side quest and then we will wrap up for the night. But next time on Thursday, we'll do some side quests. Basically the ones at the Paragon. Okay, that's a struggling anointed person. At the Paragon station thingy over in Agartha. There's a number of side quests, there's an investigation quest, and I think two action quests that I want to do. The investigation quests tend to go pretty long, so I'm more or less readying myself for a spicy one. I think I've done that quest previously, but it was in the old version of the game, so it might be different. Old trucks need repairing. Now, who could have possibly damaged these trucks? Who would possibly be responsible for these things? Let's assess conditions of things then, shall we? Yeah, couldn't have been anybody we know, obviously. It certainly wasn't me who stuck a head of corn in this fucking tailpipe. The classic case, man. Alright, so that one's fixed. We just need to find another car battery and a spark plug. We've seen car batteries before. But I guess going all the way to Markhart's mansion isn't really an option right now.
Have you become anointed?
But yeah, I would say there's a decent chance that the Thursday stream will be the last time we'll be playing this game for a bit, at least for a bit. Just because, like I said, there's a lot of stuff I want to stream as well. And I'm looking forward to getting to the other stuff to stream. But this has been quite the project. I've really enjoyed getting to really sink my teeth into this game again and go through it in a very comprehensive way. Certainly more comprehensive than when I played through it years ago. Lots of stuff to appreciate. And hopefully more on the way. Hopefully the devs are at least incentivized to keep going, just because I like what I've seen so far, and I would love to see the story continue if possible. Our spark plugs are concerned. If I could yank one from this truck or something. Maybe this one out back. My plugs are teensy tiny. Didn't even notice the animal well over here. Aha! Several spark plugs, perfect. I'll just take one of them.
Foundlings, if you feel any confusing thoughts, please see an anointed right away for guidance.
In 10 seconds, I'll be able to use my boost, but it might be too little too late. Well, that's weird. My bot shows my bot appears to be offline. I think I'm still alive though. I think it's okay. But the bot thingy is going offline. Maybe it needs to be like reconfigured with the keys, like the login keys, so that it's synced with my account. That kind of thing. I just looked over and I was like, stream offline. It's like, I would sure hope not. Nah, I think it's fine though. It's a spark plug friend, and the truck. There we go. I'll take the good boy points now, thank you. There we go, did I do good?
Job complete. Well done.
I sure did. 1 point for all that. Just a good old-fashioned grease monkey, that's what they call me. Nobody calls me that. Nor should they, because I have zero exposure and or experience with cars and things of that nature.
We're
very little by little leveling that thing up, but it's going to take a hot minute to get that one leveled up in any degree. I wish it was a Signet, because if it was a Signet, we got lots of perp buddies to throw at it, but that's okay. Alright, so... yeah, that's it. That's it for New Dawn. We did this place all the way through. Unless there was new stuff at nighttime, but nah, I'm fine with it. I feel pretty good about covering the bases pretty darn well. Let's go back to Agartha, where next time we will begin with the Paragon Station, where we got like a bunch of other side quests to do. But that is it for the night, friends. Let's find ourselves a raid target and get the heck to bed, because it is late and I am tired. But this is like I said, this is good though. I feel good about knocking out just about everything that I'd wanted to do in this cool game. Whoop, that was a little weird. Okay, we're good. Okay, that was a little weird. So yeah, this is what we're gonna be doing next time. We're gonna be using this to warp around to different spots. There's a step in time, which I'll definitely want to do. Piece of the road. Yeah, there's a few other things too. There's I think there might be one other action quest that's also worth trying out, but I don't know how to reach it necessarily. But there's stuff that I think becomes available after you beat Tokyo and once you ascend to item power 250 plus. I think there's a few other quests that are available. So we got quite a lot of stuff to do, but there's fun stuff ahead.